You got the touch. You got the power. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the live stream this Sunday. Hope we're all well. Jordy Paul here, Magpie Movies. Let's bring in the man with the power, Mr. Dudun. The Fett is here.
Sorry, we also have them.
And we have Peter's asleep. Peter's died.
Who is? Pete. That's the same face it was last week, in the same shirt.
I've got thousands of them.
So, Mr. Ainsley.
What the fuck was that suit you were wearing in the intro? You look like
That was my James Corden skit from when I did this the same mode, and I just put it straight in there.
It's a prime Arnie.
What did you think then? Is any good?
Yeah.
It's all right, man. It's all right, yeah.
Only did it about 10, 15 minutes ago, so.
You said that. You told me you're working here for about fucking 9 hours.
Shh,
so I won't try to swear. But I promised I won't say come tonight.
Okay. Yeah. You can't say cunt, you can't say fuck, you can't say minge, and you can't say shit.
What else can I say? Is that it?
E.T. and pedo are fine.
Don't fucking work.
Everybody's a bit of a cunt sometimes.
They are.
They are. So we shall quickly go into the comments. So Scott is here. Good evening, Scott. You need it tonight.
Yo.
We shall Scott. Be entertaining him. Rob's made it.
Yep, I'm here.
Rob's here.
Bugsy Presents has arrived. So, good evening. We have Martin from Man of 4K Steel Report for Duty. It is Martin, isn't it?
Yeah. Subscribe to that man. You wait, you see, here, this guy's 4K collection. It's like, damn!
Is it better than yours?
Yeah, it is, actually. The 4Ks are, yeah.
I actually tried to steal some of Pete's 4Ks and I was at his ass. He rumbled me.
Yeah.
Phil's here. The legend.
Even I know your bulge ain't that big. It's 4K. Hey, Phil. How you doing?
We have Lauren with the Brundle Fly in the picture. I sent Lauren the link for Late Mungo when it went down to $12.99 and then went up to $15.99 and then got cancelled.
Way to give a shit about the fans, eh? You know, and just, you know, oh no.
If anybody wants to watch Late Mungo now, let me know.
Yeah. Thanks, man.
We have Jess, who's I'm guessing he was on. Well, he was on with Jason last night. So it's nice to have you with us this evening. Colleen, yours here, fresh off the back of.
Hope you saw your intro, Zach.
Yes,
what
with his music.
What the hell happened with Jason the other night? What was it? I think I woke up at like 3 a.m. and they were still going. I was like, I fell asleep like this. Yeah, I look up, and his live stream was still bloody going.
Was he still there? Was he like, just asleep?
Oh, Jesus Christ, they were still going. Him and Jay.
What I will say, because we've got 20 people watching, is that there's a company, UK founded, that are based in America, called HD Movie Source. The link to their YouTube channel is in my description to this live stream. Phil had problems getting King Kong, the Scream Factory one, or the Shout. Is it Scream Factory or Shout Factory?
Shout Factory,
isn't it? Shout Factory. One of the factories. And he got in touch with them, and they got in touch straight away. I've messaged them on my Instagram. They say, I'm already to give you a shout-out tonight, guys. And they're like, yeah. So follow them on Instagram. Follow them on YouTube. Like I say, HD Movie Source. They specialize in 4Ks. They're based in America. Help fill out. So if you want your 4Ks, very similar to WoW HD, get yourself involved. Yeah. So that's your big shout-out to HD Movie Source tonight. Give them a look. The chat. They are indeed. They are very. They love their. Start with off of VHS. Had a love for DVDs and movies, and they moved in to like the Dolby and the DTX, and they're very much want to give a service that they've had from previous customers in the past. So, yep, so good shout out to them. We've got here, hey, Carl, great. Yeah, enjoyed the stream tonight with the moviegoers, not moviegoers, oldest foot movie reviews, should I say. What else we got? Oh, I'll keep going. Mental Movie Man, good evening. Hey, welcome. Matt Howard. Right, Matt. Now, I believe Matt was on Jason's stream the other day, and he's asked me to do a review of the 800 because I finished watching it last night, I think it was. So, yeah, so I'll hopefully do that. I know Big Paulie's done it, so I'll see what I'm doing. Peter the Bullet. Is any? Oh, here we go. Anyone got in the cinema this week? I'm off to see Those Who Wish Me Dead, which I believe is Angelina Jolie fire, bushfire situation.
Okay. Fire in a bush.
Yep.
I'd put it out.
Right.
Fingers
crossed. I am obviously jobless at the moment, but I've got a £60 Odeon gift card I've had just before lockdown. So I don't know if it's still valid. So, you know, I might go and see him walk on back. And legally, maybe Spiral.
They've got to be valid for 2 years.
Okay. Maybe Spiral. It's sitting there doing nothing. It's not. I haven't got money to spend, but it's a voucher. So we will go. Probably Spiral, and then I want to give Mortal Kombat some love. I know I keep going on about it, but I want to see it on the big screen.
Spiral hasn't been getting much love, has it?
No.
It's mixed stuff said. You know, people say it feels very much like one of the original ones. But because I don't like the later ones, but, you know, each their own. People hate Jigsaw, and I think Jigsaw's all right.
Yeah, Jigsaw's all right. Yeah.
The first two, though. I mean, whoa.
The first one's a classic, isn't it, really, to be honest, with regard to Saw movies.
See, people that say they guessed. I see, you know, everyone had that friend that said, I knew that was going to happen at the end. I genuinely didn't have a clue how that did end. Did any of you guess it?
No. What about the second one? The kid was in the room the whole fucking time. I mean, Jesus. I was like, fuck off, no way.
Well, Saw's a classic. That just amazing. Yeah, I mean, definitely. It's one of the, I think the, I wouldn't say it's guilty pleasure because I'm not guilty for watching it, but it's one of those films that isn't, not everybody likes. It's a bit like The Purge. The Purge and The Saw to me are two franchises that I really like.
See, I think Saw is up there with Final Destination.
Yeah.
Final Destination is a consistent series that. The ingenious deaths and how they're going to kill people off as the series went on. Obviously, I'm working my way through them at the moment. But yeah, I'm really enjoying going back to them.
That, you jammy bastard.
It was all right,
fucking,
wasn't it?
Fucking quid. Quid.
The thing is, I walked in there, picked it up, thinking, I've never seen it on Blu-ray. Is it new? And I left it.
That's 20.
And then walked around. And I walked around, yeah, and I see the trading price in CX, thinking, surely not, because they didn't do a 5 movie box. There is 5. But they didn't do a 5 box set.
No.
And it's a nice box because you haven't got a 5 spine. So I like a contained series like that.
Yeah. Well, I used to have that one and I sold it along with 5 and 3D to get more 4Ks. Now you've got that. As with anything else, anybody else gets when you've sold it, you want it back, don't you? So I'm now going to be on the hunt.
Well, guess what's in the post for me right now? Of course I found it, but I found it for £7.
How did you find it?
I saw that and I thought, I've got to get it back. So it's on the way.
Where did you find it?
Using Magpie. And they usually do it for about £17, but it was there for £7, so I went, yeah, bought.
You're still there now?
Is there another one that's in 3D in that box set? Because it comes with 4 pairs of glasses.
The last two do. The Final Destination and Final Destination.
So the first one's the aeroplane. Second one is the car, the road. Third one's the roller coaster, is that right?
Yep.
What's the one with the elevator in the shopping centre? Is that?
I don't know. Another four.
Well, NASCAR's 4. NASCAR's 4, isn't it?
Yeah, and the bridge is 5. Number 4, which is the final destination, is 3D, as well as the fifth one, which is in 3D.
Okay. And there's another one. They're working on new, aren't they?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
So anyway, we're about to go back to Carl's questions. Anyone got the cinema? Touch wood. I'm hoping to go and see Gladiator on the big screen on Friday if my mate isn't working.
Is it wasting money?
I told you I'm not working.
Oh, sorry. I meant my real friend.
You have a mate. Oh, right. Okay.
Yeah. The one who looks like Pete, but he's not. Yes. So touch wood. I haven't seen the cinema since 2000. I can't wait to go and see it again. So, yes.
Do you want to see my pickups for today, guys?
Oh, is this an exclusive?
Snakes
on a plane.
Seven Samurai. Isn't there a Arrow collection of that, though?
That's BFI.
Okay.
Crack in the World.
Never even heard of it.
That's when you bend over, isn't it?
Wonder Woman Bloodline?
That's the one I've got in Powerland, isn't it?
Yeah.
I thought you already had that one.
No Bloodline, isn't it? Oh, yeah, I got that as a double pack. Well, I got a single one now.
Get that Big Paulie?
No.
I haven't heard of that one.
And I got the Real Heroes version of Van Helsing.
That's good, because.
So I think I've got like 10 of those now.
I'm still not the biggest fan of Van Helsing.
Did you read all the shit about Rhea and the 4K? Rhea, whatever it's called.
It's supposed to have bad thingy like Donnie Darko, isn't it?
What, they fucked that up as well?
Yeah.
They're
coming out Tuesday, not Monday as well, aren't they? So
What do they call it? It's not the picture rate, but it's like the Donnie Darko 4K. It just kind of goes like that, and your eyes are all flicking.
Yeah, bit right.
Yeah. Yeah, so.
That's probably
because
they rushed it, isn't it?
My mate Jimmy's here. Now, Jimmy, as you can see from his logo, does things, and as you can probably see from my Instagram, I post pictures from Jimmy that he does. He did send me loads of pictures because I want to kind of give him a shout out. His Twitter page is T_Lofi, like that, but also just the letter. And he does loads of art stuff. Now he has sent me pictures, and so whether they're gonna, I can't put them on here, Jimmy, because the I've got to sign up to get it. But he has sent me loads of pictures that he does. Now, bearing in mind, he does all this on his iMac. So there's one of them. If you can see that, it's all very much around like greyhounds.
Okay.
Oh, that's a picture of his Willie. No, I'm only joking, Jimmy. So you can see, yeah. So I'll try and load them up onto... I just want to get Jimmy some attention because he's just a great artist, and I just want to get him... I'm doing loads of plugs here tonight. HD Movie Source, my mate Jimmy. So if you follow Jimmy...
They're quality. It would be unfortunate if his surname was Savile, but so he should be all right.
It's true. His name is... His surname... I'm not going to give it... Whatever, but... Yes, if anybody's watching this, go and look for my mate Jimmy on Twitter, T_Lofi, and give him a shout. There you go. That's your shout, Jimmy. Batman's in the house.
Hey.
Or Spider-Man?
No, it's Batman.
No, he's just got into... I don't think he liked the Spider-Man, but it's revisited him, and now he's got a love. He's found a new love for Spidey.
I know, but I do know that Jimmy is Batman. And he lives in Britain.
Yeah, we know him as Batman.
And... about an hour from me. Can't wait to see the new Conjuring. Yes. I've never watched the Conjuring series. I don't think I've watched.
I think it lost its way. Lost its way a bit, then after about two was its pinnacle, I think. And then it went it came out at the same time as Insidious, so I always got them confused. I liked two, then it went all prequel and then another story that weren't connected. I don't like the end of it.
Oh, tell you what, you know when I went to get my jab today, they gave me a t-shirt. To go with the jab, I don't know if.
Oh dear! Is it a T-virus? You can have a bigger cock. So that'd be an inch now.
No, sex change, isn't it?
So yeah, so not bad. So I said I'd give them some advertising. So NHS is now sponsored by Umbrella Corporation. So hopefully I won't change during this. But yeah, that's my joke for the evening. I hope you liked it. I'm going now.
What joke? I missed it.
Oh dear. Launch, but they had to go and release. They had to put the wrong price. Had to go and realize put the wrong price on Late Mongo. They did. Disappointing, really. Disappointing. Where are we? Everyone's talking to each
other. In America, they would have to honor that, wouldn't they, back in the day? Because they'd normally have to honor it for trading standards, but.
Because they haven't been released and they haven't captured any money, then they don't have to, do they?
No. Really?
Platina Guy, hi guys. How are you all doing? Well, yes, we are spot on. Jimmy's like, when's the next quiz? I don't know. We haven't really got into it. We've obviously, just to give a shout out, Movie Cave Jacob was supposed to be on the stream tonight. I know we're 15 minutes into it and I've completely forgot. But he's kind of double booked. So he'll be on another one. Next week we've got Leon, which I'm really looking forward to. And then the week after then we've got Durant, Dave, Durant Cinema over in America. So that's going to be great. Is he going to understand any of us? Is he going to be offended by any of us? More than likely.
He'll fucking love me.
Why am I going like that? No one there. This one.
What? So I don't say anything to offend people. I just speak facts, don't I? I speak what people think.
You do?
Maybe. Stupid side. What's going on? I'm fucking... Sorry, I had a bad hair day. So I'm playing Resident Evil all day.
Hello, Mr. Robert Fett.
Oh, how you doing, mate?
Speaking of the quiz, here he is.
Hey.
James is in here.
There he is.
What, that pose?
Yes, James, you'll have to explain us that pose there. It very much reminds me of that Leslie... Remember when Leslie Grantham was on that thing? He was like...
That's a bit right, said Fred, isn't it?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Deeply dippy. Gary, deeply deep.
Again, everybody watching, go and subscribe to Gary. Great guy. Forgot his Instagram channel. Great service, always. I'm after loads of free movies tonight, aren't I? No, I'm joking.
And have a subscriber mail next month. Here we go, Tuesday. Boom.
John's here. All right, John. Booksy, I've just started my own channel. I suffer with dyspraxia, so I'm hoping this will help me. I'm starting by reviewing different actors and eventually want to be able to do Rory David on YouTube. Yeah, I mean, I've never done for my channel. Gone out and done a hunt. I mean, when Rob came and visited me, he did all the filming, and I don't kind of do that stuff. I might integrate it, but I just, every Monday, I don't have the ability to go out, and I don't go out shopping that much with having the kids and everything. So if you've got the ability to go and do that, spot on, do it, man. I always encourage anybody who thinks they're going to do a YouTube channel to just do it. Look at us, three idiots. We can do it.
The main reason why, obviously, Paul couldn't film anything, because he was in awe of me. Because I was there, he just kept looking at me, thinking, oh, my God, he's here in person. And he had to sit down because of the situation in his trousers.
This is true. I couldn't walk very far. I mean, when you've got a one-inch erection, it's hard to move around.
It's hard.
Yeah, very hard.
Put your keys away. But, yeah, obviously, it's just confidence with the filming. You know, if you go in there and ask the stores if you can film, 90% will say no. You know, you just kind of do it discreetly. Just don't go around doing this. I know you've seen videos of us doing that, but do it discreetly. Even if you just make notes of what's in stores and just talk about it. You know, for many months, as you knew before, I was just hands. Now the face is on camera. And yeah, it's just confidence.
We're only just getting over that. We're only just getting over
that.
I know. I wish it was just the hands.
And Bugsy, if you wonder where your 6 subscribers just came from, it's me. You know, 6.
All got to stick together. All help each other out. If you need any help with editing, any help on doing videos?
I think I might go. So what I'll do is, while we're live, I'm going to try and find Bugsy Presents on YouTube as we speak, and I will send him a sub, because I love it when new people start up, and I'm more than happy to support new channels.
Yeah, the bell icon's turned off, though. Other than that, it's good.
Where is it? There we go. And subscriber number 7 is Magpie Movies with Jordy Paul.
And if I'm not on there, I'll do it later, because my internet's shit. I'll just crash it.
Yeah, you'll start disappearing off here, won't you?
Yeah. And if anyone would like to join us at any time just for a chat or just pop up and ask a question in the future, just let us know. You know, we're all kind, nice people.
Yeah, sometimes. I mean, we have spoken amongst ourselves about if it's just the three of us and one of our guys or one of you people, lovely people who are watching us, want to come onto the stream, then just say you do. And then what we'll do is I'll send you the link for StreamYard, and then you can stay on for 20 minutes, half an hour, depending on how you feel comfortable doing. And then
get Legion of Doom on here.
But Leon? Leo?
Yeah, Leo Ridgway, yeah.
He's just joined the Blue Tube community group today, I think. So, yeah, I messaged him a few times. So, yeah, we'll get him on.
Yeah.
I'd like to have that. Cool. Scott's off to see Spiral on Tuesday. I expect a full review of that from Scott. What is that movie set you mentioned a few minutes ago, please? I just missed it. HD Movie Source. If you go to this, the description in this video on YouTube underneath here, if you get rid of the live chat, the link to their YouTube channel is in there. There you go. And there you go. That's just loads of support here. Saw 4K coming out tomorrow.
Also, Mental Movie Man, the guy who's just on, he has got a YouTube channel as well. So check him out. He's not done any content for a while, but he's top bloke.
I shall subscribe to him in a minute as well, because I've done one. I don't want to keep going, jumping off. But I will. What's his name, by the way? Have we got a name?
Well, his channel name, hold on.
No, his name.
That's Dave.
Or Dave.
Hey. Or Dave.
My name.
David. So 4K is out tomorrow, as long as speed 4K. I've already got speed 4K because my iTunes upgraded. So when that comes down in price, I might get the physical.
Yeah, so you haven't really got it. You've appropriated it digitally while they let you have it. You've not got it physically.
As far as I'm concerned, I have it. I've paid $3.99 for it in HD, then it buffered up. The same with Saw is $3.99 on iTunes at the moment as well. So that'll probably go 4K in the next couple of days. So, but I don't know, because I was watching it. I didn't see any different picture quality with speed 4K from what I've watched on the Blu-ray.
No, I didn't see much of an improvement.
It's not on that US iTunes.
I watched speed today.
From where?
A friend.
Okay. 4K though?
Yes.
Okay.
He says that with Deadpool.
For my mate Keanu.
Rolling Bushes.
Playtime is currently watching Public Enemy with John. It is. That's about John Dillinger.
I've got 3 copies of that if anyone wants one.
Did you get the Poundland specialty one? In the little weird digibook. Was it a digibook?
It was a steel book. A steel book.
Because the metal pack. Yeah, I got the metal pack one, yeah.
Just what next film I want to see at the cinema is a Green Knight. Have you seen the trailer? Yes, Jimmy, I have.
I have not.
It looks interesting, is what I shall say. Next, it depends when it's out. Because Jimmy's, depending on Jimmy's working pattern, he normally comes with me, is that still Ghostbusters we need to see. And I want to see Mortal Kombat. If I had the choice between going to the big screen to see Mortal Kombat or Kong versus Godzilla, I'd go for Mortal Kombat every day. But that's just me.
You can watch it at home if you want.
Have you seen it yet?
Nah. I only get to watch it if the missus wants to watch it.
Just tie her up.
What's that above your head there, Pete? Is that... Hang on. Is that... Oh, yeah, it's a big thumb. That's what it was. Yeah, thought so.
I can't say anything because you're going to hear someone running up the stairs in a minute.
So we'll wait here, yeah, while you go get your balls out of your missus' purse.
Who, me?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
Exactly.
What's the new Wrong Turn movie yesterday? You can see why Rob didn't like it. It's had a bit of some midsummer vibe to it.
Yeah. It's an unnecessary reboot, I think. So, you know, it doesn't need... It's like Cabin Fever. Cabin Fever didn't need a reboot. But they rebooted it. And it's just no originality. They tried to do something different with the story, but it's balls.
I didn't mind it. I thought it was all right. If it was like £6 to buy on Blu-ray, I'll probably get it.
Look at stuff before, like stuff like Texas Chainsaw Massacre, Halloween, the remakes that have come from them, The Hills of Eyes. All of them are quality remakes, where this one could almost be straight to DVD. But it was, wasn't it?
Well, technically it was, yeah. As Jimmy says, it's a good film, but it's not a Wrong Turn film. Because Wrong Turn, Wrong Turn is all about interbreeding, isn't it? I enjoyed it.
It's an excuse, because it's called Wrong Turn. It's not a Wrong Turn film, but... It's called Wrong Turn, so it is a fucking Wrong Turn film.
Just wrong name.
Yeah,
maybe.
David has put. Is anyone pre-ordering the Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory 4K?
Yes, I pre-ordered the Steelbook. Not letting that get away.
I'll be honest, I'm not a big fan of that film, so I won't be.
You disgust me.
I like it. I'm fond of Willy.
Yeah, I love Willy.
I don't know. I think when I was a kid growing up, Willy Wonka wasn't bad.
I wonk over Willy.
As a child, you preferred Willy. And then as you got older, you didn't like it as much.
Yeah, got stuck. Yeah.
Yeah. Have you John Carpenter's Prince of Darkness picked it up for a quid cash generator.
I see that. I bought that
on the double, because they re-released that They Live, Escape from New York, and The Fog, didn't they? The four of them on Blu-ray. And I got that one because I'd never seen it. And I got halfway through it and I was bored out of my mind. So I sold it. And it's not like me to do that because I like all the John Carpenter stuff. But I couldn't get away with Prince of Darkness. Just thought it was boring.
I got a kick in the balls yesterday. I went to watch Bloodfather with Mel Gibson.
What?
You can't, I bought it off of eBay. It's only got Dutch and German languages in it. No English soundtrack. So I'm like, you motherfucker. And I bought that like a year ago. So there's not much I can do about that.
But what copy did you buy?
Well, it said it was Region B.
So it wasn't the UK release?
No. But it says it still
said Region B. Do you want me to get it for you?
Ah, so I'll find it. Don't you worry. It was like, fuck.
Going back to the Carpenter stuff, a film that I think deserves a I think They Live would have, you could do a remake now of what's going on with the world. I don't know, commercialism and stuff like, you know, we always sold stuff for Amazon. You know, I think that would potentially make a good remake now.
Yeah, of all the stuff, because you shouldn't make Halloween, although Rob Zombie kind of tried to did. You shouldn't make a remake The Fog, although they did and it was terrible.
Yeah.
This is a really bad example. Prince of Darkness I've never done. They Live. I could see that being a kind of a good reboot. Obviously it won't be as good as the original. That's the problem, though. They've got to try and live up to the originals. That's why no one's ever touched the thing, ever. They're trying to do
but make it a sequel, then. Make it a sequel. You know, some of the aliens didn't leave. You know what I mean? Make it a sequel to it after all these years.
Yeah, to see what the follow-up was.
Hmm.
Not bad. What about you? I like Hostel more compared to Saw, although I thoroughly enjoyed Jigsaw. I've got all the Hostels. I went to the cinema to see the first Hostel. That's really going back a while. Picked it up yesterday alongside Project X. I've never seen Project X. And an unused light box sign from a charity shop for $2.50.
That's a good deal.
Yeah, cool. Not bad.
There's bargains out there if you look. You know, I was always in a really weird frame of mind going in charity shops because I thought I'm not an old pensioner. Why would I go in a charity shop? For years when I was younger, I wouldn't go in there. But now I've got no issue in helping them out and going in there and having a hunt.
I don't know why, but I think it's probably brought up because my mother. I always used to go in there to like charity shops and think to myself, this is just dead people's clothes.
Stop sniffing them.
Oh, it's just what happened last week with obviously Jason going in there to get some Blu-rays and then obviously Paul running in there or Pizzo running in there. And I'm like, what's what? And just, you miss them, didn't you? You miss it.
And then Jim
just like what happened with Destination.
In his latest video, didn't he? That was funny.
Oh, Scott, your most good friends. What's the latest foot news?
Still an antibiotic, still about an inch wide, the hole is. I'm going there Tuesday to have it all fixed up again, and they'll cut bits off of it, and it still looks gross. That's about the only news at the moment.
Is it all bandaged up? Like when you like bathe it, do you have to take all the bandages off, or literally you have to leave it till you get it looked at?
Well, at the moment, there's two pieces of cloth inside the hole, which are infused with silver, because when something gets moist, the silver is like a catalyst for killing any germs. So right. they've literally blinged the hole, for want of a better word. So, and while that's on, when the hole closes up to skin, then they'll put iodine on there, and that'll keep it dry. But the silver's in there because that'll stop any germs getting into the open hole, and it'll start granulating, which means they're going from this to like that, you know. But it's a long process, and I've got to be careful. I can't stamp my feet or anything like that. I've got to be careful.
That's all. When the missus comes in, you can't put your foot down anymore.
No, stick it up her butt.
I've got to make sure Jack don't climb down the beanstalk then.
Fall with it. Jack, yawning.
If you was a character of Resident Evil, you just need a fucking spray or a herb to sort yourself out. Have a little spray or just eat a herb, you'd be good as gold.
Oh, hang on, guys. Hang on, guys.
Oh.
Oh, hey! The Paulie! There he is. The legend.
How you doing, fellas?
Have you been on a sunbed today?
No, that's my super duper lighting system. Well, I wouldn't call it super duper, but look, do you want me a bit of red? I'll have a bit of red.
I'm not happy with this.
Bit of blue.
Have you got a bit of brown there?
Yeah, I did that when I got home from work.
So this is what I don't like, Paul, because look at the size of mine to the size of yours.
I know, look at that. Look how many buttons I've got on mine.
Look at that.
Right, we're talking about size, hold on.
Not Rob. I've got the small one here, son.
Put the focus on.
I've actually got one of these buttons here. It actually says wipe ass.
Excellent.
Does it use the rear thing behind you?
talking about asses, obviously we're getting a new bathroom fit, and we're getting one of their bidets. So I'm going to be all about that. I might do a video of it.
Unboxing.
just don't come out and drink and use it as a water fountain.
Oh, dear. No.
I thought you were working tonight, Paul. I mean, you're not working this weekend. Or did you work
last night? Yeah, I was finished at 8 o'clock.
All right. And you come home to be...
I saw Rob's little message, and I thought, oh, shit.
Wait, what?
Do I go on and talk to a load of losers, or do I keep your dead company?
And we won! Yeah.
And you won! Yay! Probably only for about half an hour, though.
That's all right. It's fine. It's a
we might have some other surprises potentially coming up soon.
Oh, yeah.
And it's not coming out of Pete's arse when he has a fart.
Thank God for that.
And you'd be proud of me, Paul. I've only said the C word once.
He only has... once? Oh, wow.
Yeah, it was the first word. But it was the first word.
Four times, count five times.
Jesus, anyway. So Paul.
It was just after Paul pressed the live button.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah. Straight away.
I might start all my videos. All my videos are just the word. They'll come up, welcome to Robert Fred's Panty, and I'll just say it, and then it goes into my intro. But
you could do that Alan Partridge thing.
Yeah, Steve Coogan, isn't it?
It's a quality song, isn't it? But the wife hates that video.
Yeah, everyone's a bit of a cunt sometimes.
That's filmed down the road from me. It's filmed in North Yorkshire, that was, in Skipton. Interesting fact for you. So there you go.
Is that because no one ever goes there because it's too quiet from so they can film it?
I've got to work in that area, so I'm not dissing North Yorkshire.
Yeah, I see what you mean. It looks like I've just come out of bloody Donald Trump's arse myself.
Yeah.
Lovely.
You ain't been working, you've been on the fucking beds, mate. You lying cunt. Oh!
Jesus. So, Mr. Bowman, you did your review of the 800.
I did.
I haven't done my review. Yes. I would give it one more than you.
Would you really? Wow.
Yeah, I'll give it 8. Yeah. I thoroughly enjoyed it. It wasn't as... I think because... I know these guys haven't seen it, but other people who are watching this might have seen it, but it's just the scale. Because if you look at special features, it showed you how they made... just completely made up that section and the building and everything. It's just and they kind of did the color of the picture. It wasn't normal. It was like gonna
sepia.
It's hard to believe that the actual scale fucking dwarfs Saving Private Ryan.
Yeah, it's just it was one of those films that you hadn't heard of. And then I saw a few people pick it up and talk about it. So I thought, well, I'll get onto it. I'll jump on that bandwagon. And I watched it over a few nights. And I thought it was just, I was really, really impressed by it.
Did you catch up with the subtitles okay at the beginning? Because they were really frantic.
Yeah, because it didn't really have an introduction, did it? Opening credit.
Yeah.
Because normally you've got presents and all that. But you could tell it was an expensive movie because all the production teams and like companies, it was like two or three or all four of them.
One thing I did notice that the credits were still going up half hour into the film.
Yeah, it was funny. But also you had obviously the English and the British over there. It's just, I think, I don't know, see, you've got to give it your score, and if I do my review, I'll give a different one. But I just want people to go out and watch it because I think they would enjoy it.
It's one of those little hidden gems, isn't it?
And for the price as well.
Well, I don't know if it's the same price as Amazon now.
$7.99 now.
Is it still the same price?
No, $7.99, not $6.99. It's gone up a pound, fucking hell. Still worth it.
Yes, just thought I'd mention that because I haven't had a chance to speak to you about it. What we got here?
Considering the DVD's still in Tesco's for about £7.
Yeah, I think a lot of people might not be wanting to watch it because it's subtitled, but I would say to them, just watch it because it's there's a lot of action in there which kind of oversees it.
I used to be the same. I used to snub subtitle films. You know, I ain't got time to read this crap. You know, I want to watch a film. But
someone has made a someone has made a dub of it. There is a dub going around. I don't know if it's going to be incredibly racist. I don't know it's going to be. But there is a dub that I've been looking at earlier.
Of
800.
Hey!
Oh,
shit.
What is that?
That's a pound man. That's a pound man, that is it. It's the furry look.
There we go.
And now there are only three people watching.
It's John Lennon.
Jamie, sing us an Elvis tune.
Anyway, Mr. Powell, how are you?
Very well, thank you. How are you?
I'm all right. Thank you very much for sending me that movie again the other day, Intruders.
That's all right.
I appreciate that. And it filled up my Friday.
Through the window.
Thank you.
No.
Oh, good. You got it. Marvelous.
Thank you.
I've got a bone to pick with you as well, Jamie.
Okay.
Because of you, I had to buy that.
What is it? Oh, good.
I haven't seen it. And you said you bought it. And I was just like you said, you'd be meaning to watch it. And you never got a chance. And I thought Sony was selling it on eBay for like £4. I was just like, well, give it a go.
Yeah, it's meant to be like one of the best films ever from that country. So, and I've been wanting to see it. And I found it in HMV. I thought, I'll have that. Thank you very much. I'll be watching that probably tomorrow, hopefully.
Depending on when the stream finishes, I was going to put it on tonight. But I think when it gets late, I don't like putting subtitles on because
it's 2 hours and 20 minutes as well. So you need to...
Fucking hell.
Does anybody else feel like they're talking to a pedo when you've got that wig on?
Creep captures.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
He looks like an old Dennis the Menace, doesn't he? or your school teacher that you definitely thought was a pedo.
Yeah.
Yeah, you look like a math teacher.
Yeah.
I want to see the blobby costume in the background. Where's the blobby costume?
That's right.
Get that blobby costume out.
Here we go again.
I think you should run outside and show the people the hearse.
Jamie, why don't you wear that?
I got nothing on
your
feet.
Next Blu-ray hunt. But make a detour past the school. Christ.
Jesus.
I'm not a pedo, but if I was, I wouldn't go anywhere near you, ginger cunt.
Underneath the wig is just loads of sweets.
So are you picking that up then, Jimmy? So is that tomorrow you're going to get that one then, yeah?
What is it? I can't see it.
That's the Beatles anthology.
Oh,
with your haircut, I thought it might be.
Oh, that's a waste of money.
I ain't got nothing to show off.
Your haircut?
It's not a haircut. It's don't put anything on it. It's got like a side put off.
Pete, lower your face a bit. Lower your head down. I'm going to punch
Where's
you.
Where's this going?
I can still do the side tugs.
Circumcision coming up.
Side tugs.
I'm just going to poke you, Paul. Yeah. Hang on.
Rob's getting one as well.
I feel quite safe.
Yes, we are grown men. Honestly, we are grown men.
We are.
Well,
we'll say that. When we was all in my car, we were just singing along to 80s cartoons.
That was amazing.
Oh, yeah, we were, weren't we?
I have a horrible feeling that if I had actually made that and came with you, that Jason would have to sit on my lap in the car.
Maybe in the boot.
That's why he was disappointed.
He could have sat in a booster seat. He'd be fine.
Yeah.
You could have sat in a cup holder.
We was going to put Pete in the chair and strap him to the back.
Okay, it's
pretty hot. Just go fucking...
roof rack.
Yeah.
Mr. Bean on top of his mini.
That's right, yeah.
It was a good day, but fucking 9 hours of driving just fucked me.
Yeah, you look so tired that next day, man. You look knackered.
I know, because you weren't supposed to come on the stream last week, and then you came on, and you were like,
ugh. Yeah, he's like,
oh, my dog's grown up.
What Loki's about. I'll go to some questions, fucking seeing as bastard. This is kind of like supposed to have like watch your interaction. Like,
we just need Kermit, don't we? Where's Kermit?
Oh, I forgot to say, oh, yeah, sorry. Jimmy's J_Loaf on Twitter. Go on to earlier. I was giving a shout out to a mate. So, yes, sorry, not T Loaf. T Loaf is his dog. J_Loaf is his. Yes, so that's right. So, there you go, Jimmy. That is out. So, you two missed all that. One I apologize. Letter. Yeah. when your collection is full, would you sell some movies but have the same amount of buy and put on binders? Love you all, Wilson.
I would never put films in binders. I know. James Whitelaw does.
My DVDs are binders.
I can't do it. I did it like about 10 years ago with some of my DVDs, but it just did my head in and I got rid of it all. But my collection will never be full because I want everything.
Kind of defeats the object, doesn't it, really? You know,
yeah.
Lovely slip covers, lovely collections. I couldn't bring myself to do it, really.
No,
I've never been a slip cover guy. I mean, the first slip covers I've kept are from my own Studio Ghiblis, but I've just never liked them. But, you know, people benefit. Oh, Jason Laverick, I received your parcel. Thank you very much. More fodder for the competitions. And a Hugo 3D steelbook. Thank you very much.
Pete,
I've never seen them.
I've dug out a pile of steelbooks that high for you.
Does that mean I've got to give you that blowjob now?
I should change you out to your own in the picture.
Oh. Jesus. What do you mean there? You've already paid him for it. You've already done it.
Paul, that envelope tasted weird. Thank you, Paul.
I think there was a point. Wasn't there a point that all of us, I think, back early in the day, that none of us liked slipcases? Because I remember getting rid of loads. And then I started collecting them again. I'm sure I got rid of a lot. I think a lot of you guys do as well, didn't you? Or might have been me.
I've always liked it.
When you got rid of his plastic covers, when you got rid of those, you know, when you got rid of all of them, yeah. I thought that was sacrilegious.
Yeah. I mean, I could have sent them to you, but they were in such a bad state. And, you know,
it takes 20 minutes to get a fucking film out of that.
Yeah, I know, but I've spent only £300 on them.
They were just, it was just really annoying having them on the shelves because, you know, it didn't flatten. You know, the plastic didn't flatten on the spines and they were all sticking out and I couldn't get the Blu-rays in, you know, all nice, even. You know, half of them were sticking out and I thought, stop it.
Too much air in them.
Yeah, possibly,
I don't know if I go the other way, though.
I've just noticed, Rob, there's a question for you here. Sorry. Which you mentioned to me earlier on today. About the director of the movie Frankenstein's Army claimed the design of one boss in Resident Evil Village was stolen from the movie.
Okay. Yeah, another thing, obviously, I watched the video. That's not the first time Capcom did it. There was a film called Dagon in the 80s, which is pretty much the whole story of Resident Evil 4. It's literally, take Leon out, the main character. He goes to an island with a family. There's a craze, there's like a cult in there, in a small village that take people with pitchforks. It's to jump out of windows, and there's technical people in it. That is Resident Evil 4. So there's issues, I think, with a couple of the characters in the new one that are based on that film. 100%. And I finished it 5 times then.
Only 5?
I know. James, which is that picture, because we said to him, what's going on with the picture? And he said his wife bought him a picky cat for Christmas one year, so he thought he'd do a cheeky pose. Is it very much?
I've got one of them fucking caps.
I know. You got everyone. That was great. That wearing it.
It looks like a kind of Edmondson. It's a cross. Yeah, it's a cross between Peaky Blinders and Bond. You know, with his gun.
And a sprinkling of Right Said Fred.
And only falls and horses.
We've got our very own Right Said Fred.
It is. Same. All he needs is a fucking egg, isn't he?
He may be Fred, but there's nothing right about it.
I'm saving up for a comb over. This bit stayed, that bit fucked off.
You should go Hogan, Hulk Hogan, just on the sides.
Well, there's something on the side of his head right now.
Yeah, have you got a bit of hair stuck on the side of your head from the wig?
What is it?
On your left-hand side.
I can't see.
Gone now.
It's gone.
Awesome.
Phil said that UK Speed 4K is rubbish. All the extras are being removed, and the Blu-ray only comes. Trivia. Yeah.
That's Dick trivia. That is Dick trivia.
Well, the art.
Okay. I am a fan of the Steelbook.
I don't like Steelbook. Looks meh.
I do. I like it.
Oh, okay.
That's too much orange.
Nothing. You
never have too much orange. That's what the wife tells me.
Too much orange, says the orange face.
says the tango man. He's been tangoed in the bottom, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Let's really.
Do you remember the tango ever? The guy running around slapping people.
Yeah, that got
banned,
didn't it?
Is my face gone orange now as well? No.
No, it's always like that.
No.
I like orange. It. I sent you guys a picture of my new suit, and everybody decided to send me a picture of James Corden. I said, I showed the wife and went, I asked the guys what they think of the new suit, and they were like, she was like, oh dear. And I was like, I know.
It's the first thing that came to mind.
I was kind enough not to.
It wasn't the first thing to come to my mind, and I didn't post it.
What did you think?
We'll
move on from that.
I couldn't repeat you.
Scott said he'd love to come on at some point, but we'll have to go outside to do it, though, whatever you're comfortable with. Can I say a big thank you to Peter, who's been amazing, helped me launch my 4K Steelbook channel this weekend. Hashtag legend. Yes, he made me aware of it, and I subscribed.
Wait, that first video, what he's got behind him, you're like, that's 4K, that's 4K, that's 4K, that's 4K. Yeah. All right,
great first videos. 100 to what, 91 or so? Really good start.
Yeah.
I wish I was that.
We'll definitely all sub and help you out.
Yeah, definitely, man.
It's all about building the community. It's all about building a legacy for the British YouTube community is going strong. You don't see anything like this anywhere around the world. It's about top people.
Too many people are in it just for themselves, you know? In between us, you've got 6,500, you've got nearly 1,000. We've probably got near 1,000 between us three, so, you know, that's like nearly 10,000.
I've got 20.
And if Kermit was here, we'd be on about 20 million.
Yeah. I swear he's on 3 million and just didn't want to tell us.
Exactly. I just love it helping everybody out. Again, Paul here. I like that. Paul Tams, hope you're well. Because I was on his live stream earlier on with Movie Massacre 1987. He did a good stream this afternoon. I said to come along and join ours. But yeah, glad to be back in cinemas. There was that Indian COVID outbreak scare, though, isn't there? That might push things back.
I don't agree with that. From Monday, they're saying
it's local lockdown.
Wear a mask. I'm like, no, come on.
I don't think there'll be a national one. They can't do a national one. It'll just be local ones.
Yeah.
Yep. I was talking
to Amy Wife in the background.
Oh, I thought somebody in the background.
Yeah.
So I did have my first job today, so I am now on the way to being immune.
Give away.
Hi, Katie.
Hey, Katie. Like the hairdo.
Yeah, they can see you. I'll turn you around. Hang on. We'll watch it on the
TV. It's very small in the background. It's like a...
I'll move it back. There you go. Hi, Katie.
Get me off screen.
Tell you what, Jimmy.
Got her hair done, so.
Speaking of which, Jimmy, it always reminds me, I forget to tell you this, but I like it have you got as do all the time because you make me aware what T-shirts to do. I've got my Bill and Ted one from there and I've got my Sonic one from there. I like it when you go and then you put them on so I know if I'm going to go, like Katie does with Primark as well, you know, all the Stranger Things stuff. That's why I got my Stranger Things hoodie because of that. So it's good, especially where everybody goes out, like Paulie does. Those two don't bother to go out.
I see your T-shirt. That's just reminding me.
It doesn't matter. I thought that would catch on. It hasn't. But hey, you know, it's an idea. I need to do Laura Loves. I need to do her horror tag.
Yeah, I've just done that.
I saw yours. I haven't done mine yet.
No one tagged me. I'm the horror man. What is going on?
I'll tag you.
You're a horrible man. It's a difference.
It might not be a very wise idea for anybody to actually tag me. You know, I know fuck all about horror.
Yeah.
Or general knowledge.
You fuck you, you cheeky bastard.
I was only half a point ahead of you.
Yeah, I'm asking about when. Oh, I forgot. Oh, I'm stumbling. James asked earlier on, Rob, when are we getting these blind shitty boxes again?
Oh yeah.
Oh, soon. I'm working on it. It's going to happen. It's a shitty video, you know. So it's going to take time because I can't be arsed. But it is happening. But it's going to be funny. I've already got a bit of input. It's going to be good.
Yeah, but the problem is the input that we've given you is going to be longer than the video itself.
At the moment, yeah. So I've got to work on that. Can you sort out? Yeah, it's been a come.
I might have another go at the old pop boxes tomorrow, actually.
Well, hey, because you got one last week.
Yeah, I got a red one last week. Apparently, you get some whole new stuff in a blue box.
Fucking is this HMV?
HMV, yeah.
You know, you can open them up. When I was in the one at Lakeside, all of them are seals open. You can open them up to see what's in them. They're not sealed up.
Yeah, they are. They've got sellotape on them.
Well, the ones I see, when I was going to put like two boxes in one. It made no sense because on the top of each pile there was generally one open. I thought that was all of them, but why would they show you what's in them? Because you're going to because it's normally shit, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, at the moment, yeah.
Well, because you got something, and then like you got two. What two did you get?
I got Trading Places.
Eddie that Murphy. Was it. Yeah.
And, yeah, that was a cool.
Which is all right.
I don't know what the fuck that other thing was.
I think it's anime.
Was it Zantra or something, or Zerdra or something?
Zerdra.
I'll probably buy two and get fucking Midsummer.
I'll have that one. Sell that one to me.
Paulie, I've got the other one of Trading Places if you want it, so you got the matching set.
As long as you haven't got the other one of the other shit.
No. I don't know. I'm not even sure what that is.
You I never know. I might open it up and there'll be bloody Gladiator in there.
Well, I know some of you
like
that.
Paul's got his tickets booked for Spiral and re-release of Total Recall. As you all know, I already told you what I'm going to go and see. Birds of Prey, straight in, tomorrow night. All over it. But yeah, you'll be going back, won't you, this week, Paulie?
Tomorrow, Godzilla versus Kong at 1:15.
Have you Jamie's got a book them or can you just turn up?
Hey?
Do you have to book them or can you turn up?
Could you send you that?
It's probably best to book them.
Yeah, I'm going to see it as well, but there's an issue with the Limitless cards for Odeon. They're not working on the website, so I've had to book my ticket, pay the normal price, but it's all cheaper. So I'm going to find out tomorrow what's going on, because the Limitless isn't working across any of the members across the country. So I'm going to see Kong and Godzilla at 5:15. I'm going to see the big iSense screen as well, which is going to be awesome. But
so yeah, if you know where Jamie lives, you know where he's going to be. So, burgle his house, nick all his films and his chocolate.
Right.
We've got Odeon gift vouchers for Christmas. I don't know if you can use them on there.
Yeah, I'll have to... yeah, you can.
Because I might go and see a little film that I've seen a few times.
Mortal Kombat.
Have you seen? Maybe. I thought you hadn't seen that yet, Rob.
No, it's supposed to be all right. I've heard that it's shit.
Yeah, don't listen to those reviews.
You'll probably like it before you've even seen it.
Yes, probably. Yeah. but I'm not listening to the stuff on Spiral, because Spiral, I think, it's supposed to have a really good opener and then go downhill. I'm not a big fan of Chris Rock, but I'll give it a chance.
Was Chris Rock in Lethal Weapon 4? Was that Chris Tucker?
No, it's Chris Rock. Talking of that, tomorrow, Saw's out on 4K, and I was thinking of picking that up.
Spit it out or swallow said. It.
Hey, put it back in pants.
Did you see the steelbook of Saw that the Best Buy had? How good was that?
That's nice.
Cause it looks, yeah, because it's the slipcover on the steel is plastic and it's got the lines on it, like looks like a TV. So when you slide it out and it's got a big face of Yeah.
They re-released all of them unrated over there.
So Saw is going to be a first-time watch for me. What can I expect?
You can expect to be taking the piss out of by us for not seeing it before.
Yeah. Well, what happens is at the end...
No, don't be a cunt. Yeah. Come on. Let him be a Saw virgin. Come on.
It's all of them, to be honest, all of them have got good good thing. The first two are really good. The last one's pretty good, and they'd be in between.
Yeah. Yeah. The twists and turns at the first one are good, and the second one is really good as well.
But you must have heard the twist, Paul. You must have.
What's that?
Obviously, with Saw, have you been? You know nothing about Saw at all.
Only like from various trailers and people showing various bits. I know nothing about the whole concept of it. No.
It'll cost you an arm and a leg.
Never had a chance to watch him.
Oh my God! Did you just say that?
He did, yeah. After you've watched all them, you can watch the Hostel films.
These 4Ks are so expensive. No, I like Saw 2.
No, Fartfest or not, was that?
Didn't you give all yours to Jason?
Rob? I did, yes. I was going to sell them all to him, but obviously, I don't like selling people stuff. So I gave them to him. No, he bought them off me because she's still watching.
I'm just going to start with the first film and see how I go from there. If I get to the end and think, oh, fucking hell, I don't want any more of this.
No, it's more, I wouldn't say it's a horror. It's more suspense, I think.
Psychological, really.
Yeah.
You think you figured it out, and then it will smack you in the arse.
Oh.
Sounds good to me.
Just let the film enter you. You'll be fine.
Yeah.
Yeah. James wants to know if this is going to be a fart fest tonight.
Mate, I've tried about four times.
I've just had dreams.
Dave's put, I can't wait for Lost Boys to come out in 4K. Yeah, that'll be a first day buy for me, yeah. I think, Lost Boys in 4K.
I like the first and third one. Second one is shit. The first one ain't the best, but one is a classic.
I've never seen the other two.
An awesome soundtrack.
Yeah, I've got the soundtrack, yeah.
I still want to punch that prick with a bloody saxophone, though. I mean, how he even got into the film?
The dance at the beginning. He's on Cameo. He's on Cameo. It's one of them. You can pay for him to do a little video for you. And he does all that.
You could do that as your intro, Pete, if you wanted to get involved.
No.
Oh, my God. That would be perfect, wouldn't it? Right.
Have you seen the end of Dave Durant Cinema's videos when he has his Patreons coming up at the end?
Yes.
Keanu Reeves playing the trombone or whatever it is.
I think so. Yeah. I've got to practice for 2 weeks tonight, and they're going, get to the chopper, and all that kind of stuff. That's all that stuff.
Hot chicken nuggets and all that.
Put the cookie down.
Yeah. Put it down.
I don't know what the hell
Jason's good at that.
Himself into.
I know. Should have got Jason on.
Yeah, he's good at that.
Put
the cookie down.
Yeah. Come on, leave or delay. I can't do it.
And you should all have pictures of Megan Fox in the background as well.
I think the last time I tried to put a picture in the background really backfired when I went on Moviebug stream, and I know he hates Rise of Skywalker. So the Rise of Skywalker post in the background and the Rise of Skywalker t-shirt.
I can see it in James's face.
He was demoralized.
So, because I'm going back on in next month, I think. So I'm going to try and think of something else to do. It's like one of the times when I did my, with people at work, when we were working from home, we did like a Teams meeting or whatever, and I dressed up, because everybody at work, as you said, I used to look like Mr. Tumble, so I got dressed up as Mr. Tumble for the stream. So I had the red nose and the spotted face, and I had a thing on, I had a little bag.
I knew I'd seen you somewhere before.
Yeah, that's where it is.
That's when you was hanging outside them schools, wasn't it, saying you was Mr.
Yeah,
Tumble.
That's another pedo, isn't it?
Pedo on a playground.
you got Mr. Blobby, and now you've got Mr. Tumble there. Look, you've got a double out there.
Yes.
Hey.
Oh, God.
Fingers and thumbs, we should call ourselves.
I've got a red nose on my cock, so it goes,
you've got a red nose on your what? What was that? On your cock? On your cock?
It's like... You're talking about that, aren't you, mate?
We're going to have all new names. It'd be Robert Fett's Fisting and Blu-ray Bugger Brit.
Jesus.
And Big Paulie, you can just stay Big Paulie.
I'll have to change my thing from Magpie Moves to Tumble.
And it could be Jamie Pound.
Hey, I'm Tumble. Do you want to fumble?
Oh, Jesus.
As fur.
Look at that. We did it, guys. 59 minutes, 54 seconds, and we're talking more pedos.
We talked about it well before that.
And no E.T. E.T.'s not been mentioned. Andy's bombed me then.
Well, I gave you a shout on Instagram earlier, Rob. When I gave you a shout on Instagram, I did put the picture of E.T. on it for you.
I did see that.
Yeah.
Fucking, he's a fucking pedo, isn't he?
I can't. Most of it is, though, I'm giving Rob all these shout outs on my Instagram account. And he's getting more subs than me. So it's working the wrong way.
Well, to be honest, I think it's down to content.
Well, in that case, then I should get more. That's what I'm saying. You know, my James Corden opens.
When we went, when we met up a couple weeks last weekend, we went into Go Poundland, and Robert Fett goes, "Right, Robert Fett is here. Robert Fett Bounty is in the building."
And nobody gave a fuck.
Robert Fett's Bounty has entered Poundland. Anybody want
Clear
to
the way?
Do you not know who I am?
Yeah, your other half looks really embarrassed, didn't she?
She was. She's right behind us. I don't do it all the time.
Let me do some. Look, stop hijacking my stream, bastard.
Questions?
Yes. Have to wait until the end of December for Snyder's Cut of Justice League 4K.
Why?
Okay. Why is that? Where's he based?
Is that to pick it up or?
Because it's obviously out. My payment has been taken for the Steelbook already. It came out yesterday. I know that Phil's having problems with it though.
I'll have to wait till I get a job.
Yeah, if anybody's watching this and is in the Liverpool Warrington area and would like to give Mr. Robert Fett Bouncy a job, contact him via Instagram, Facebook, Messenger, fax, pager, mobile, and any other things.
Just remember though, Geordie Paul's accent, it was job, not blow job. Job, as in work.
Well, saying that, if the money's right.
If the money's good.
If the money's right, I'll take a load.
I mean, soon.
I'll take one for the Blu-ray community.
Blu-ray blowjob. That's what I changed the name to. Blu-ray blowjob with Geordie Paul. Should change it. There you go. BG movies with Geordie Paul.
Yeah. Robert Fett gobbler.
Robert Felt Booty.
Where's this going? I've lost all the things here. Where are we?
I don't know.
It says they could remake They Live, but they can fuck right off a Big Trouble in Little China. That's a fair point.
Yeah.
The thing is, what I understand. Mortal Kombat's inspired by, isn't it? Mortal Kombat's inspired by Big Trouble, I think, with the lampshade head looks a lot like Raiden, doesn't it?
Yes.
That's true.
Every time I watch Mortal Kombat now, I'm like, I wish I had that enough money and the kids didn't fucking live here anymore. And I could go downstairs and I could buy one of those massive arcade machines of Mortal Kombat 2. So it's free and I could just have it on there all the time.
£300 in Smith's.
Is it?
Smith's Toys, they do one-up cabinets. Yeah. They're £300. Yeah, Mortal Kombat Trilogy.
Oh.
And they've got a Ninja Turtles one.
That's right, I've seen that.
In one of my videos last year, they had them in Dame Westwood Cross and I was playing Pac-Man.
So when mine turns up, it's definitely a subscriber mail from one of you two, one of you four.
I was just about to say that. I don't know how I'm getting away with a big, massive arcade machine, a subscriber mail.
Three quarter size.
Yeah. You can buy a stand that goes underneath them to make them bigger.
Yeah, that subscriber mail excuse doesn't work. It says, well, why is it got print? Why is it printed and why does it say your name on the envelope?
Why is it sent to you?
Yeah. It was subscriber mail, like, honestly.
So I managed to find Show Dogs and the Mask brand new sealed £2 each charity shop. Also picked up a few seasons of Thugs Park DVDs. Not bad. Yeah, I don't know what was going on with that mask you found there with different size on the different.
Yeah, it's weird. That's really weird. I don't. Maybe it's just a re-release and they just did a different design for the spine. But it was. I just thought it was a bit odd to find two spines with the same film, the same front cover and the same back cover, and the spines were just done differently. What the face was at the top and then. Title at the bottom.
I still think I had the best charity shop pickup. Two of them. First one was that £2 Bond box set that I sent to Paulie. That cost me £2.
£2?
Yeah, from a charity shop. Yeah, couldn't believe it. I didn't tell you that because it's not worth Bond, obviously, £2. And obviously, the destination for £1.
Bloody hell.
You almost coughed up the lung when I bloody saw that for £1.
No. You're still missing number 5, aren't you, Rob?
No, one of the guys on your group bought it for me this morning.
Oh, that's good.
A guy called Andrew, he picked up for me. So I do have 5 coming, which I think is supposed to be shit anyway. Is it? Does the end of the first one start? So it's a, I don't know.
Yeah.
Complete spiral, I've heard, but.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, I'm enjoying going through them again. Like we said earlier, it's like it's a franchise like Saw that each film, it's a good franchise all the way through.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, that's why I shouldn't have sold mine. But
there's not one shit disaster setting for them. You know, you've got the suspension bridge, roller coaster, the freeway. They're all brilliant.
What's the one with the like escalators? Is that a part of the last one?
I think that's just part of it.
And the swimming pool where the guy gets sucked through the swimming pool. His arse gets caught on the bottom. Is that 3? No, 3 is the roller coaster, isn't it?
Roller coaster, yeah. But they have so many through them anyway. I can't remember which one that was.
And there's another one. They're working on another one as well. Sorry.
What, reboot?
I think so.
Yeah, the end.
Maybe like Fast and Furious. Didn't they do Fast and Furious? The Fast and Furious. And then it's confusing them titles.
Lawrence, I hope you feel better soon with regards to your foot there.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, Pete, for putting up the 800 Blu-ray offer on your Facebook page of the day. Picked it up, but not watched yet. Looks truly epic. Oh, yes, well, we mentioned that earlier on.
So many people thanked me for that. I'm just like, passing it on, you know. Loads of people were like, oh, yeah, I'm jumping on that. I think Amazon need to give me some backenders on that one.
I actually misread that. I thought Pete was giving away 800 Blu-rays out of his collection.
Hello.
What about if everyone watched? Everybody watched 800 and everyone thought it was shit. Can you imagine it?
Yeah, thanks, Pete. I want the $6.99 back, yeah.
It was fucking awesome, though.
I've not seen it yet.
You bought it, though, haven't you?
Yeah, I've got it. The wife got it for me from birthday, so.
What? It's very good.
The 800.
What?
What? She's what?
What?
You what?
Goes back to work tomorrow after 7 months.
I like the way people are going back and I've fucked off. That makes sense. I've worked all the way through it now.
He's got your job, hasn't he?
Yeah, but Mark Mia's got the Wales Comic Con.
Yeah, I spoke to him earlier about it. He's one of my Facebook friends. He's the Mass Effect guy.
The one who does my intro,
sorry.
Okay. I've got you.
You're watching Robert Fitz Bounty. Him.
Yeah, he's a voice actor. He does Mass Effect and he's done a few films.
Are you mates with him on Facebook as well, eh?
Yes.
Do you know him, do you?
Yes. You've got to follow him, haven't you?
No.
I don't speak too much. I was sending a message saying, look, I've got a YouTube channel. Do you mind saying a few bits of my video? And he said, give me 2 hours. And just sent me a video. Like, all this stuff with Cameo where you've got to pay for these videos. And they can be quite expensive. He just happily sent me a video. I've not spoken to him for about 6 or 7 months previously.
How did you get to know him?
I met him at Comic-Con.
And how did you get his number?
I met him at London Comic-Con. And then I was sharing pictures on Facebook. And then we're talking through Facebook.
Oh, okay. Jason's in the house.
Hey, there he is.
No, I didn't see him there. It was just a small message. Sorry.
Stand up a bit. Don't get up.
Everyone saying hi, Jason, like that. Hey, further, it was good. 25 minutes behind the chat. Come on, Paul. Well, I'm trying.
Only 25?
Looks here. Hi, Big Paulie. The quiz winner is here. Oh, look at this. Jimmy's put the quiz. Don't give Jimmy a big head, Jimmy.
Quiz cheater.
And he did admit cheating, didn't he?
Yeah. No, I did not.
Yes, he did.
He didn't. No, Groupie said he was cheating, didn't he? I forgot about that.
Yeah.
Oh, Big Paulie's number one fan. What a picture
that
is.
What the fuck is that? Fucking hell. What is that?
What?
I don't know, but I'm subscribing to that channel right now.
Oh my god.
Jim, when are you doing a complete Blu-ray video?
To answer that question, when I hit 1,000 subs.
Okay.
How many you got left?
But what about if you hit 1,000, you hit 1,000, then lose 60? Would you still do the video?
Yeah.
Okay. Not saying you would.
No.
No, of course not. When I hit 1,000, I'll guarantee I'll go down to about 300 or something.
It's the milestone. When you hit the milestones, you do lose a few, don't you? It's all red.
Yeah.
James is going to be my last winner this week. Back to work on Sunday next week. No, I'm not moving. What are we going about the next quiz, man? James, you have to quit your job.
Yeah, fuck your job.
Do a robber.
Live off food banks and be with us.
Oh, yeah, James, you can quit your job and Rob can take over.
Yep.
And then I won't be here. Bastards.
Yep. Damn, you saw that plan, didn't you?
I've finished all my application forms I've filled out. I've said I can't work Sundays.
We have got this as well. Any update on the Birmingham meal? No. That's the answer
to that question, isn't it?
They're just getting dates. We have to get a weekend when we're all free and also have the weekend when people aren't working. Benefit
Robin
for me
in.
Is...
Thanks.
What?
And the trouble with me is my weekends, every other weekend, I'm Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So I've got to try and do it. We've got to try and do it so that it's the off weekend.
And I'm the opposite to
Paulie. I think I'm the opposite to Paulie because I have the same problem. I work Friday, Saturday. So it's, and I think we work the opposite weekends because this is my weekend to work. Is this your weekend off? Or
no, it's my weekend working this weekend.
Oh.
Well, you know, you both got to quit then, haven't you, really?
I've had a word with Lulu and Claire, and they're both up for it.
Oh, fantastic. Cool.
All right, but what about the meetup? Not about what's happening afterwards. I mean,
I happened to mention that there's a rather large Primark, and that was set in stone.
Yeah, I think the wife would be going there whilst we go around the vault.
Oh, they are.
I think same as well. When I've been mine, she'll be like, I'll just palm her off with everyone else.
Why is it go that way?
That's right.
Yeah, to be honest, I said to the missus, I said, "Oh, Katie, I love going to Primark. You go that." She goes, "Don't be sexist, Paul. I'll be going to the pub with Rob's wife." I said, "Okay."
After Primark.
After that. But yeah, I guess because I don't work weekends. Well, I do. Not that many. We just got to basically get everybody's dates between now and I think September, end of September. Put them together every weekend and just see if we can.
We're working.
Yeah, I think we're currently penciled in for September 10th,
2027,
isn't it? Yes. I'm working that weekend.
Yeah, I'm
planning on being in lockdown, haven't we?
At the moment.
We've been all zombies then.
Yeah. I could be dead.
I've had no after effects from having my job today. The missus said she felt like her arm was a bit heavy, but mine was fine. It's just coming to go and see.
The thing is, since you've had your job,
you're just a little prick.
So, since you've had your jab, you think.
Paul, you said
you had no nothing side effects, but since you've had your jab, you've become incredibly unfunny.
And looking more and more like James Corden.
I've got to book mine in, but every time I have the needle, it just keeps snapping in my arm.
Because you're that hard.
That's what it's. Is that where you're supposed to have it?
Yeah.
No, I need to. I keep having letters about it. I've got to do it.
Yeah, I had a word with my nurse when I had my second one. She said, "Would you like a sticker?" I said, "Oh, well, fucking lollipop, love."
Well, I was going to it, and the missus like, "Are you going to be all right?" I'm like, "What?" She goes, "It's just a little scratch." I said, "I've had that down there done where they stuck a fucking needle in that. I think I can handle the arm." And she's like, "All right."
two pricks in one day.
Yeah.
How is your cock anyway?
Don't talk to me about that, mate. Until you've had a camera shoved up your ass, and then the fucking doctor said that's the biggest colon I've ever seen, then you ain't even competing with me.
Hey, it's not a competition, all right?
I hope they didn't put that footage on YouTube.
No, but they had a TV in front of you, so you could actually... Do you know, it's the worst thing ever when they put a camera up your ass and you can actually see it, because you just see your hairy ass crack, then you see the last shudder of your dinner as it goes in the hole. And you see all
these. You should have that as your intro. Going down the tunnel and have like Bullet Presents.
It's like that Superman swirl. It's like last night's dinner.
You should have Blu-ray Bullet Shit.
With a sweet corn.
Yeah.
Blu-ray Bullet Shit.
Yeah, the non-Disney version of the Black Hole.
Oh, it's X-rated show tonight, guys. X-rated. It hasn't got X-rated. Wait till it gets after 11 o'clock, then it'll get X-rated.
Oh, yeah, we'll fuck you up, yeah.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, sorry. What are your thoughts on the TV series Line of Duty?
Don't like it.
I'm yet to watch it. I haven't got an opinion on it yet.
I was just going to see if I can mimic that.
I love it. Me and the missus absolutely love Line of Duty. We've got absolutely, we adore it. We've watched obviously the new one, and we're going through and watching from the beginning again. So,
is that right?
Jamie, you're having a stroke.
Oh, hey,
not that you see, no. Mr. Johnson's well prepared.
Who's picking up the Backdraft 4K?
No, I ain't got 4K.
I will be.
It is a quality film, but
I don't want to pay full price. I will get it, but not full price.
You know, I'm a sucker. I always pay full price.
Of course you will.
No one puts Paulie in the corner.
Jake's here. Good evening. How are we, gentlemen? We're good, Jake. Thank you very much for coming on and joining the stream.
I'll say, gentlemen, is he talking to us?
He's got the wrong channel.
He's talking to the two on the bottom. Fuck the ones on the top.
Ah, yes, of course, yes. Not this riff-raff up here. No.
Yeah.
Honestly. Hey, we keep this live stream going. Remember?
We may be cocks, but you are cunts. So we cocks.
Fuck.
Cunts get cocks. I am what I eat.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Let's move on. We went to HV yesterday and found out the random pop boxes are just two random pops from the 2 for £10 clearance pop range they sell. I asked one of the managers of my local HV.
Too bad.
So they're just rewrapping shit then.
You need to get cash generators boxes. That's a future right there.
You could even do like a video on it or something.
It's time for the shit that I bought.
No word of a liar. I've opened one of them and it is bad. That's all I'm saying.
Probably put him in the Flowerpot Men soundtrack.
Jimmy's put, Rolfie, can you get Nobody? Really want to see it.
I think the look of that film.
I think I already have it.
Have you not seen it, Pete? I'm sure you've seen it.
No,
you've got the link as well, Bob. I haven't seen it yet.
Oh, okay.
It's fantastic.
Yeah, I've had the link.
It's quality.
Yeah, Jimmy, if you are watching this, hopefully, because we're 3 hours behind everything. If next time you come and see me, bring a memory stick and you can have Nobody. Not that I have it or anything.
Bring the memory stick.
Yeah, just bring a stick, not your memory. But yeah.
Bring your stick. There you go.
Yeah. Zip. Nice legal activity live stream there.
Any charity bring shop button tomorrow?
Might be a bit.
I might have a look. A
little bit.
I might have a look.
British Art Foundation.
Have a peruse.
Always come up with Blu-rays.
I bought that at British Heart Foundation today and realised I fucking got it.
I'll
about 2 quid each, isn't it? And that is British Heart Foundation. They're all about 2 quid each, isn't they? £2.99. They don't go cheaper, do they?
Yeah, Oxfam.
Probably
like £5.99. £5. Oh, sorry, I'm finished.
I can never find blue. I can never find Blu-rays in charity shops for like, three for a quid or something.
Oh, my charity shops aren't on the rubbish. They never have anything. Obviously, they're not rubbish because they do a good work for charity. But when it comes to Blu-rays, they're not.
Yeah, fuck the charity work. We just want cheap Blu-rays.
Rob, do they do the arcade Star Wars game from the early 80s?
The original one is coming out on 1UP. Smiths will be doing it. But the Super Star Wars on the SNES were the best three. But the old school arcade one, even that X-Wing, that is coming on 1UP, haven't it?
Is that the wireframe one?
Yeah, yeah.
Where you got the trench down the Death Star.
Yep.
Yeah. Oh, I love that. I used to play like 3 hours when I bunked off school doing that.
Yes, it's coming on 1UP. I think it's about £3.50, I think.
Oh, I might have to give myself.
Where's this going?
But you can get it on working on your mobile phone too. I can get it on your phone to work.
Love that.
It's easy done. Next!
Oh, who's this?
Oh, what's this?
Who is it?
Who's coming?
Is it going to be? Is it someone short or what?
I don't know because it's. I'll have to.
Is it someone with shit internet?
Yeah.
Is it ginger poops?
Is it a ginge? Is it a ginge?
Is it a hobbit?
Ginger.
I'll take it off. Oh, and if no, you're watching, come back on when you, because your camera's not coming up. I'm going to surprise us, guys. Anyway, Tony's here. Great stuff again. Thanks, Tony.
All right, Tony.
Film that scared you the most?
American Werewolf in London.
TV show, Ghostwatch. Fucked me up as a kid for years.
Me too.
Fucking couldn't sleep. Oh. But, it's shit now. Oh, or the entity.
It's shit now,
the entity
God,
as well.
Then, that scared the shit out of me.
Sinister is the most.
Not being scared, Big Paulie.
It's because he doesn't watch anything.
Insidious. Insidious bosses.
I tell you a film that there we go. Is Schindler's List.
Hey!
Hey! It's the quiz master instead.
Are we doing it?
Hey! Hello, Dane.
Hello.
Na 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 na.
It's right, said Fred. We've reunited.
Oh, hey, it's funny.
So we got Bold Bolt, Tufty and Sin.
This looks like a couple of ball. If you put your heads closer together, it's like a couple of ball bags.
There he is.
Like walking behind an elephant, isn't it?
Alexa.
Ah, dear me. How are we doing, James, anyway?
Paulie's got a bit of thread blading.
Good lie.
What's Paulie doing?
He's got right to Fred on.
He's got his Ray watching mitt with him.
I'm too sexy for my shirt.
Too sexy for my shirt. So
Alexa, shut the fuck up.
Does she answer to that?
Have you ever told Alexa that you're her father?
Alexa answers to everything I say.
Like, Alexa, I am your father.
What is 100 and Welsh?
Zip it.
Always a bit.
Anyway, James, are you okay? Welcome to the stream.
Cheers. Thanks, Paul. Thanks for letting me come on.
That's all right. You messaged me, and I thought, yeah, we'll let you come on because you said you're working next week, so this is your final Sunday.
Yeah, so we're good enough. Quit your job.
So, will you be working every Sunday?
I think so. I think I finish about 10 o'clock, so I might be there for the last half an hour or something.
Well, what you could do is you could do the quiz, send it to me, and I'll ask the questions.
Okay.
Just take the, I'll take the credit for it. And then we can make sure that Paulie comes last again.
Yeah.
Okay.
Secretly message James then.
What was that message for me?
Are you being genuinely serious? They picked the blonde booze up at a charity shop.
Yes. Yeah, I sent it to Big Paulie.
How the hell was that £2 though?
I laughed at it. I was going to give them more. I think because it was in there, I think they thought it was a book. That's the only thing I could think. It's a heavy fucking book.
I think the Game of Thrones steelbook set is then.
Colouring
pens or something.
Here we go. Ready?
Yeah.
Did you know that we're all on IMDb? Yes, I did, but I have no idea who created that.
Probably Paulie's number one fan.
Movie Bug, didn't he? What a Movie Bug streams.
It was one of his streams, but I don't think he did it. Because he's never mentioned it when I've spoken to him. Didn't even know, never actually asked
him.
What am I on there?
Yes. James isn't though. Sorry, James.
Too new. You're too new.
That's all right. I'll just stay in the corner.
That's all right. I used to make cocktails for a living before we went into the most recent lockdown. I was was let go the day before and often serviced few celebrity groups, including Charlotte Crosby. I did not see that Charlotte Crosby is a celebrity.
Who's that?
She's from Geordie Shore.
Oh, no. Yeah, I know. She was in Big Brother once. Was she the one that wet herself?
Yeah, she used to piss herself all the time, yeah.
It's like up here, people call me Joey Essex, and it winds me up. That's my accent.
Well, to be fair, you came to my house and said hello to my daughter, and you made her cry, so you just got to change your accent.
And she's named the fucking pigeon after me, isn't she?
She has.
The fucking pigeon.
Daddy, look at that. I'm like, yeah. She goes, that pigeon, it's called Rob, like your friend. I'm like, oh, okay. She goes, because it's big and round. I'm like, oh, okay. Oh, she didn't say that. I'm just making that up.
Nothing to do with stool or anything there. Stool no. Pigeon. No.
But yeah, so I have a pigeon in my back garden called Rob. So there we go.
Very nice.
Can't take off because the girth.
Yeah. Now Rob's going to hire a cat to kill it.
Yeah. Yeah. Scott, yeah, it's been an emotional day for me. So.
Ball bag, Rob.
No. Scott's just saying thank you very much for us tonight. Because he was in a, I won't say bad place, but I think we've cheered him up and I'm happy that we've done that.
We've done this for you as well, man. We had a plan for tonight.
Yeah, big hug, Scott.
Hello, Scott. Yeah.
It's my mum's birthday today, so I've had a bit of a weird day, but I've had like 50, 60 people on Facebook giving me responses. So it's always nice to know there's people there for you, you know?
Exactly, yeah. Yeah, we all pass on everything. Yeah, look at my fat fingers. It doesn't even look like anything. Christ. Yeah.
Just the finger in the eye.
Yeah. Anyway, yes, moving on.
Well, my mum would be proud.
Anyone here watched The Woman in the Window, guys? I fancy watching it because I know Carl did a review on it. It's the one with...
I do watch Women in Windows, but I promised the cops I'd stop. So I can't run away from them anymore.
I did like Carl's video he did of that with his missus in the background.
There's a strange man looking out in the neighbourhood watch.
It's normally me. That's what that suit's for my restraining order.
Pete, you want to just stick some nitrous on your wheelchair? Been diesel it. Sorry, yeah. Dice.
Well, that's why I fart in the chair, you know, a bit of rocket.
Just out of interest, Rob, before you came on, did you put your deodorant on?
Oh, I didn't this time. I normally do. And I was going to do my hair, but I thought, no, I'll go au naturel. Comb over today, look at it.
You know not to do that again.
To be honest, I was playing Resident Evil and I was stuck on a boss, so I had to quickly rush.
Oh, okay. Oh, he's an interesting one. Seeing that I look more like Alan Jones than James Corden.
No. Actually, you're very small, though. You've got like a pier.
Yeah.
Your head's like this big.
Oh, how about that? There we go.
I can see the reasoning behind it, because they are both pretentious wankers, so... I'm having too many digs at you, Paul. I do apologise.
It's all right. I'll just put you on mute. It's fine. Right. You're on mute, Pete. I'm joking. You're not anymore. You're not anymore. I've got the power.
Can't.
Wrong time, put it on. No.
Can I not get like a beep button or something? Gary's asking again. I love Gary. He's great. I'd love to get Gary on here if he's more confident behind. And I know he's more confident behind the camera than he is in front. But I love Gary. He's great stuff.
Oh, there we go. Look.
Oh, look at that arse.
That's not the part you got to worry about, son.
Let loose the kraken. Why has he got boys' shorts on?
Is it a skirt?
Is it a skirt? Yeah.
Look, you guys want to start fucking with me? I'll get it out.
Please don't.
No.
When I said it's going to be X-rated tonight, that's not the way I want
not
to go.
Not near my head, please. Hold on.
What are you looking for anyway?
It's barely worth it. It's barely worth it, Pete.
What is he doing?
I got visions of one of those videos on YouTube where in the warehouse and all of a sudden all the Blu-ray shells start crashing down on him. Oh,
bullshit barn.
Yeah.
That was bought from Menkind, wasn't it? I used to sell them in Menkind.
James wasn't.
Oh, shit.
What happened? He disappeared, Jamie.
Can you still see me? I can't see shit.
Your picture is like a really, it looks like a really bad pirate.
Right, anyway, thanks for that.
There we go.
Sorry about that. So, Gary's asked, what's one of the best films you've seen this year so far?
Ooh.
Mortal Kombat!
I say Combat or Kong's a guilty pleasure of mine.
I've seen this year. It feels like it's still January.
And that Netflix animated film. A family one.
Oh, Mitchell's.
Mitchell's.
Yeah, that's up there. Yeah.
I enjoyed that.
I don't know. I'm trying to think.
My favourite is Nobody.
I don't. I really enjoyed the 800. That will probably be up there. Take God's
Heaven. I can't think.
Ah, Justice League. I'm going to go for that.
Yeah.
Zack Snyder's Justice League. I'm going to go for.
Probably Justice League. Or when Marnie was there, I really enjoyed that.
What the fuck was that?
Is Rocky
Steve Catch Jonas?
Peter
Weller.
What the fuck was that? I nearly shut my pants.
So, Mr. Millership, favourite film you've seen this year? You can't say No Venice Story. I know you've seen that new one this year.
I'm gonna say probably I did like Zilla and Kong, Zilla versus Kong, but the Mitchells as well. So, yeah. I'll say Zilla versus Kong.
Well, that'd be Paulie. Good choice.
Hey?
What did you say, Paulie?
I don't know. It's a cross between Justice League and When Marnie Was There, the Studio Ghibli.
Yeah, I didn't watch that yet. I've got
really
it.
I loved that film. I thought it was great.
Oh, that'd be the first one I watched then.
Yeah, Ghibli, Jamie. Ghibli.
Ghibli.
No, not Ghibli. Not happy with
Ghibli. Ghibli.
You know, I spent like £200 on those Ghiblis.
Ghibli.
One film, I spent like £200 on all the Studio Ghiblis from CX, right? And one of them didn't turn up. And one of the parcels was open. And I said this to them, and it's taken them like 3 weeks. And they said, we've got to contact the store. We've got to investigate. I said, it's a £6 Blu-ray. I spent £200. You think I'll be bitching about £6 if it turned up? And they finally refunded me after like 3 fucking weeks. It's like
which
200
quid
worth of order. My neighbor.
It's not
well. Yeah, I ordered it. I thought I better check. In the end, I've actually bought it from the store instead. But they're like, the store is saying they dispatched it, and I'm saying they fucking well didn't.
Mm. Who's got the interference on the stream?
Not me. Oh, Jesus.
There's a lot of crackling, isn't there?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not me. Crackling.
It's probably James.
Well, all I need to do is, if I mute me...
Well, that's better.
That is better.
Yeah, that wasn't supposed to work out that way.
For the reason
shouldn't be because I'm on the laptop, so
just but a bit of feedback.
Sounds like
it?
Somebody's typing or something. Just need Kermit in the action, then it's a perfect group.
Yeah, we need Kermit in here.
Jimmy's put Line of Duty and ruined my Sunday as you're watching the final. Off, yes, it was. I didn't do a stream on a Sunday because I wanted to watch that live. Not live, but I want to watch the finale. How is picking up Raya on 4K here on Tuesday, and what edition of it will you be getting? I just want to stand in 4K.
It's supposed to be shit on 4K, isn't it? It's supposed to be shit.
Yeah, the bit rate. Yeah. I want to get the steelbook.
Transfer, not the best.
I wanted the steelbook because the art's really nice, but I might just go for the normal like I did with Soul.
I want the steelbook, but Battle Royale didn't mean this one.
I'll pick it up at some point. I need to get. I haven't got Soul either, and there are only two Disney I'm missing.
Yeah,
no, you did have Soul, but you gave it to me.
Monday or Tuesday. You know what the picture quality's like.
Are you picking up tomorrow, Paul, eh?
No, it's already been shipped. Shipped on Friday, so I should get it probably Monday or Tuesday.
Is it released tomorrow, then?
Yeah.
No, it's Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Is it, you getting the Amore or are you getting the steelbook, then?
The Amore, yeah. Hopefully with a lovely slipcover.
I would have thought so.
Yeah, the steelbook was all right, but I'm kind of picky with steelbooks now if they haven't got titles on the front.
See, I think I'd only get it because I really enjoyed the film.
I've not seen it yet, but I really, really love the artwork on the steelbook. It is really nice. But
if you've not seen it, Rob will help you out with that.
No, I haven't seen it either. Okay.
Then you've got to remember with Big Paulie, he doesn't have to be picky with steelbooks because he has a $2,000 war chest of steelbook money every month from all his views and adverts and shit.
Yeah. I wish.
Are you getting any more of those screeners yet?
No, I actually emailed the chap. There is something coming out. It's like a 15-disc Blu-ray box set of something. I've never heard of it. I think it's some 1950s comedian or something, but other than that, there's nothing on the schedule at the moment.
Oh.
Yeah.
Who's farting?
Not me.
Rob.
I've been laughing.
Awesome.
Oh. Yeah. Who's getting aisle two?
At least those cars generate much better full of shit suitable to donate to charity shops.
Yeah, my mother-in-law works in a charity shop, so it all goes straight to her. Unless people want it in the streams.
The one down the bottom of the stairs. This
is the and then after Ghost Watch, you could not sleep for years.
Yeah, you can turn that one off and just leave the one on.
Has everybody seen Ghost Watch or?
No.
Do they know of it?
No. I've heard of it, but I've never seen it.
It was a TV show, and they went to a supposed haunted house, and you see all that Blair Witch kind of footage. It had Craig Charles as the cameraman. So even then, you should know it was fake. But he was led to believe that it was real. And they had loads of complaints. And I think the woman that hosted it quit her job, didn't she? She resigned.
I don't remember.
I had nightmares. You can get on DVD. I had nightmares for years.
I've got it on my hard drive.
Yeah, I had that exact same experience. I was really young enough to believe it to be true. And then I couldn't sleep for ages. It was mad. And because I don't know, because they all made out all week on this morning. They had the guy presented it, or one of the guys in it. He was like saying, "It's all real. We're going to this house." And I was like, "Oh, we're really excited about it."
It was Pipes, a ghost called Pipes, wasn't it?
Yeah.
That's it, Pipes. It was hiding in the curtain. It was terrifying.
Scratches on her face, everything.
Yeah.
I still have, flashbacks now, honestly.
Yeah, I did.
Keith Chegwin. It was Mike.
Sarah Green and her husband, wasn't it?
Oh, what?
Parkinson.
Yes, Michael Parkinson.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and Craig Charles Sarah Green. As well, I think.
Craig Charles, the cameraman.
Craig Charles. Yeah, that's right.
Simon Mayer.
Yeah.
Can I put this question? Yeah, I keep going back.
Oh, thanks.
One of my little charity shops has got a lot of Blu-rays from One Below and they sell them for £3 each. Oh, well.
Fair enough.
Bunch of white.
Good cherry, isn't it?
Yeah. So, who's eating rocks? It sounds bad. I don't know. I think there's some kind of interference.
Where's the rock fighter?
Thanks, Rob.
a little reference there.
Yeah.
Just nothing.
Godzilla vs. Kong Cinema Soirée is out on Blu-ray June 14th. 4 weeks later, it's meant to be big. Speaking of Godzilla,
I don't think it's a big loss because I think any people want to see it in the big screen will still buy it. If Mortal Kombat was coming out next week on 4K, I would still go to cinema to see it before I come out.
Yeah, that's sort of films you want to see on the big screen.
Jungle Cruise is now what's going straight to digital, isn't it?
Yes. It's got Emily Blunt in it, so I won't be all over that. I love me some Emily Blunt.
I've met Emily Blunt.
Have
you?
Blunt.
Oh, she rhymes.
Yeah, I met her.
So say Emily Blunt 20 times.
Emily Blunt. I could. Oh, shit. I'll send you a video later.
I'll tell you what. This is a story from when I was at work. Somebody had to phone up this car dealership. And one of my colleagues said, can you phone this person because you missed their call? His name's Mike Hunt. And she actually did phone them and said, can I speak to Mike Hunt, please? And all she could hear on the other end of the phone was people pissing themselves laughing. Oh, dear.
Your fan's back again, Paul.
Must be quite
I know. He's gobbling off something.
I think we should go on IMDb and rip
Paulie's banana there. We could do some Photoshop on that picture.
Yeah. Oh, here we go. Yeah.
16 candles.
No, we're not talking about what's going on in his mouth. We're talking about favourite arrow race. What is your favourite arrow release then?
Waterworld, the limited edition one.
This one, but this is going to Pete.
Man would be the thing. The box set of the thing.
Yeah, we know that, Paul.
So did you say that was coming to me, did you?
That's going to the one, yeah.
What about you, Jimmy? What's your favourite arrow release?
When?
The Birds, just because I love the film.
Thank you.
James, have you got any?
An American Werewolf in London, I think. I do like that release.
16 candles enough.
Okay. There is something. Have you seen the new Venom trailer? I have. And I was not blown away.
CGI's a bit iffy, isn't it? I just don't think they should have put Carnage in the trailer. That's the worst thing they could do. Why? Just leave a surprise for his appearance to be on the film. Just stop ruining trailers and putting too much footage in. We'll have 10 more trailers before it comes out.
We always get a weak first trailer on anything.
True.
I thought it looked good.
Apparently, I look more like Gordon Ramsay than James Corden.
No.
You know what
my
you
fucking
are?
Omelet.
You're an idiot sandwich.
I do this all the time. I'm trying to hit. I don't know. I remember I was on Jason's live stream and I hit the camera and everything fell over. It was so professional. Check out Pom Poker. It's a Studio Giblet movie about raccoons with magical testicles.
You say Studio Giblet? Say Studio Giblet.
I said Giblet because I'm not going Ghibli or Giblet.
Yeah, I've got that one.
You got that one?
Yeah, I've got more.
Oh, here he is. Love Paulie. I've seen every single video he's done since 20. I think somebody's outside your window.
If you hear a knocking on the window, it's probably their knapsack.
You know what, Paulie's just made that profile for himself, hasn't he?
Yeah. that's what that painting is. Yeah.
That clicking you can hear is just me banging my head to my own picture.
It's the arthritis.
Oh, it's big, Paulie.
Oh. I should change my name to Small Paulie. No. Okay. Dad's Army, there is the movie. No, is that Blu-ray, June 14th? Great stuff.
Yeah, 50th anniversary, isn't it?
I went to the cinema to see the reboot of that with my brother-in-law. Absolute shit.
Yeah, the reboot's toad, but the original's good.
That's the one I've never seen. Poundland, wasn't it?
How had you?
Yeah, he's seen Poundland a lot. Has a couple of good funny lines, but the whole film is shit.
No.
But it's a couple of good funny lines.
Do you know I had a real surreal moment today in CX? I went in CX in Southampton, not the Shirley one, the normal Southampton one. There was not one Blu-ray in there that I didn't already own, not one.
Oh, nothing for me to buy in there.
It doesn't surprise me.
To be honest, when I did our new intro, and the missus saw the bit I put with you in, Pete, and she went, he's got a lot of films behind him, hasn't he? And I'm like, yeah. She's like, you're not having that though, are you? No.
Well, if you say Laura's face, when Laura walked in there, he's like, that deja vu. My eyes would be like that. I won't allow it anymore.
No, this is it. This is my one shot.
I thought the extension out.
I was trying to think of a penis joke there, but I couldn't think of one.
I've only got a few. I haven't got that many. Have I?
You cocked up.
Paulie, did you find out if Blue Fans is still going, mate?
I think they're just still held up because they had problems with the licensing in with Disney China. And it just held everything up last year. And then you got the virus and everything. And because I was expecting Solo, Endgame and Rise of Skywalker, but we never got them. So it's very slow. They're slowly dripping out now, but very slow. Oh.
And you're underneath him as well.
I don't know if you ever get back to the big ones, the big releases.
There you go. Number one fan. Paul.
To the rest of you, just want to go home and I'll just stay here with me, number one fan.
Yeah, I could do that. Hang on. Here we go.
Right, now we can have some proper conversation. Now these Muppets have gone. What is my favourite video? Oh, they've come back again.
Oh, missed somebody. Who am I missing? Oh, Jamie. Where's Jamie?
Jamie.
He's not there. Oh, there he is. No, I've took him off.
He just died, yeah.
And now I'm between a cord. Now I'm between a cord and a dumb.
I'll
see you real soon.
Yeah. What is your favourite video you've ever done? You haven't answered the question.
Favourite video I've ever done? I think it was the Great Poundland Hunt with Lou. And
that's a good one, that.
Hot, that was really hot that day. We went around about 10 or 12 Poundlands all over Kent. It must have been about 37 centigrade and it was fucking baking.
There you go.
I think I've seen most of Kent last weekend. I drove past most of it.
I'm going to Whitstable soon. Anybody near there?
Whitstable?
Where is that?
I know that's near.
Damn it.
It's near.
Haven't met Paul yet, have you?
Not yet.
I haven't yet either.
Not yet.
No. Oh, is this going to be it?
You do realise, Paul, I'm going to be this lovely mess when I meet you.
Oh, that's nice.
Only because I'm going to stab you to death and I'm going to prison.
I've not known Pete for long. When I met him, it's like it's emotional because I get like this.
Yeah. Then he realised that I was 6'6" and he was shorter than me.
Not many people are taller than me.
Yeah,
I've got a change of scenery for next Monday's Blu-ray hunt down Hastings. So I'm doing some hunting down Hastings. Down with Lulu and Claire at the caravan at the weekend, and I think we're going to be doing a live stream next weekend.
Cool.
Oh, interesting. We'll be tuned in for that.
That'll be good.
Oh, speaking of which.
Yay! Let's go green for Kermit.
We may be ladies, but at least we're not ripped for her pleasure.
Oh, wow. He can't call us ladies after the photo he sent me.
I still can't believe you walked into that ballad. Ballad.
He can't call us ladies.
Dare we ask?
Has anybody seen the movie of Baba Hotep?
No.
Yes, I love that film. I love Baba Hotep. Such a quality film.
Yeah, it's amazing. 10 out of 10. Fantastic film.
Yeah.
I've never seen it.
And he gave it 10 as well. It's like, bloody hell.
Bruce Campbell is best.
Elvis Presley in the care home. Oh,
yeah. I know. I've heard of it. I've just never had any inkling to watch it, I think.
I might own it. I'm not sure.
I shall find it. I'm sure somebody might be on the
DVD. I haven't got it on Blu-ray.
Okay, 3D.
Steelbook?
Yeah.
It's Steelbook 4K 3D.
Send Kermit the link. Get him on here. Then it'd be the perfect group.
Yeah. Kermit, come aboard, Mush.
Yeah. You realise he's probably just sat there naked, though, don't you, with the laptop on his cock?
What do you think?
You
try
and, how do you do that? You try to balance that. Try and balance a laptop on it. You couldn't do it, could you?
No, it just mushes it down, mate, into nothing.
It's too big. Keeps falling off.
Damn it, look.
Oh, my God.
Oh, here we go. Toby's asking, what do you think of the new Carnage?
Yeah. I'll give it a chance. I'll give it a chance.
It'd be all right. It'd be all right. As long as it's rated, depending on the certification, isn't it? Yeah. But if it's an 18, if it's a 15, it's all right.
Well, what was Venom?
I like the Venom British 15. Oh, that was real funny.
I don't mind.
I don't see a problem in doing 18 Marvels. So sure, Blade was an 18, wasn't it? I know it was before the Cinematic Universe, but and Punisher.
Yeah, it is. Yes, it's an 18. Yeah, I thought they might have dimmed it down to a 15 when it came out again, but no, it's an 18 still.
Oh, Blade Trilogy is down to about 15, 16 on Amazon at the moment. That's been hit. That's been 20 quid even second hand for God knows.
Why does this happen when I've done all my spending for the month? Because I want Blade Trilogy. The Blade Trilogy.
Oh, do you want that? They had it in the charity shop.
What, the Trilogy?
The Trilogy of Blade, yeah.
Why didn't you pick it up
first? Well, I only picked up Destination. Beforehand, I picked up them shitty blind boxes.
I sent you money for that.
Tell you what I did see in the charity shop the other day, the HMV exclusive Bill and Ted trilogy. They only wanted £2 for it.
No, you didn't.
Oh, that's
good. Remember, there was a guy going around on Big Paulie's group that would put brand new films up and stick Paramount tickets on them, and he could basically see the top corner was peeling off. I can't remember who it was.
Yeah.
Back in the day.
Anything for attention.
I've always wanted to do a video when I go into Panland and take one of my own films in there, put it on the shelf. Well, I can imagine getting stopped by a member of staff saying there's no code in it, you can't buy it, even though I planted it. Imagine it.
Jamie's keep disappearing. Is he back?
I was going to put a couple of my Midsummers in there.
just get rid of them. How many copies have you got now?
I've still got the 7 because I've started to buy one, didn't I?
How many copies have Back to the Future you got now?
I've got 8 box sets.
Was that another 2 that turned up then?
Yeah, did you see the picture? Did you see it? Yeah. I showed you the picture, didn't
I? Yeah, I saw a picture of 2, but I was like, what the fuck are they? And then I saw, oh, for fuck's sake, you go across the top of it.
So they're 150 trading, but they're quite nice boxes, aren't they, like for films? So I don't know what to do with them. People want them.
Does anybody want any copies of 50 Shades of Shit? I've got plenty to go around.
Have you got the trilogy? Have you just got the first film?
It's just the first film.
I'm about to buy the Steelbook.
Why?
Why?
Yeah, but why not?
Well, because you want it.
It's shit.
Effect, it's shit. Well, yeah, well, I've got a normal Blu-ray. I've got it in a digibook. Now I'm in a Steelbook.
Jesus.
Oh, I have the trilogy, actually. Somebody sent it as a subscriber mail. It's a DVD collection.
You know what the funny thing is, right? Is that you don't like 50 Shades of Grey, you get sent it. He hasn't seen Back to the Future and hates Midsummer, gets it, gets loads of copies. Yeah. I hate Birds of Prey, and funny enough, nobody sent me Birds of Prey because they'll probably know it will get thrown out the window. Unless it's 4K, in that case, it'll go in the collection. Just saying.
I absolutely hate the PlayStation 5.
And I hate the Avengers 4K box set from Amazon for $3.99. I really hate that motherfucker.
Is that definitely a Blade thing? It's definitely on Amazon.
Music Magpie, I think.
No, not Final Destination. Trilogy.
Blade. I'll have a look tomorrow. Oh. Don't pick it up yet.
$16.99 it's down to. You're right, £3 off. What was the other one? Music Magpie said for Final Destination, he said, didn't he?
Let's have a look.
Thanks for watching, everybody. This is just us going on our phones.
If we just go, put the next question on, man. Put the next question. It could be the one question that we don't know the answer to.
Oh. Yeah, that was my latest pickup. Yeah. It came in the post about five days ago.
It's not there.
I like that film.
I haven't watched it yet. It's like, yeah.
It got £5.49, but it's.
Hey guys, you know, Marvel were doing those museum pieces.
No.
You know the Marvel models, they're doing museum pieces with these faces.
What? Oh, they're simply museum penises.
Oh. Yeah. I've got all of them now.
Incredible bulk.
Red.
Paulie is CGI.
Paulie is CGI.
He is.
That's Kermit's reckoning.
That's short for cock goblin in that picture.
That picture really made me laugh. When you put yourself in that picture, Paul, that really made me laugh.
That was good.
Hotel Transfer the 4 trailer is out tomorrow.
I do like them films.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Ooh, a good Adam Sandler film.
You ain't said that in a while.
Paul, you can have my Blade trilogy.
I do not say that.
Thank you. I don't know how to say that. That's very kind. What do you think of John Carpenter's film Elvis? I haven't seen it. I know Paulie's got it though. Didn't you pick that up?
I haven't seen it yet though.
Didn't that woman write the on top of it, on the sleeve?
Yeah, on the slip cover, she was writing on the receipt. And I've got an imprint, and it suggested it might be her phone number.
I think she's on the stream. She's on the stream
did
today,
she write,
I think.
Did she write help?
I'm being held against my will.
Did you say
thank you very much?
If you're paying £30 for that, you're caught in a trap.
That's out of print, though.
That's because
you know
shit.
What Elvis Presley's favourite pudding is?
In the gutthole.
Oh, my God.
I
would have
said all of them.
Can I just get rid of them? I'm only joking. It was me. I'm joking.
Yeah,
but do you know why Noddy? I'm not going to...
Yeah,
I know this one.
Because he's a.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, Rob. Luke wants to know why he hit the PS5. He loves it.
I don't hate him. I haven't got one. I thought someone. It looks like a sandwich maker, doesn't it? The PS5. It's ridiculous. It's in the size. It just looks horrendous.
Bloody awful design.
I'm an Xbox, so I'm afraid.
It's a good console.
I can't believe it's still so difficult to get hold of them. Did they not produce enough?
Well, no, it's the chipset. They're both changing them to 6 nanometer, so it's going to be about 6 to 8 months before there's even close to.
I was in Smith's Toys last week, and it said PS5. We are out of stock. I thought,
everywhere.
How long has it been since Christmas?
But you bought one, didn't you? You had one in your basket and pre-ordered it, didn't you?
I did actually buy one through Amazon, and I decided, I'm never really going to use it. So someone on the Facebook page said, can I have your order? So he sent me £450, and then I changed the address, so Amazon shipped it to him instead. Because he desperately wanted it for his kids for Christmas. So I think he's very happy with that.
So why don't you sell it to a grand?
Lockdown as well. It's in lockdown as well. It's a problem.
Yeah.
Or COVID.
True. Still, you can go to CEX and buy one for about £8.50, can't you?
Yeah.
I film them every time I go in there. I think a lot of CEX is taken out the window now because I might just get stick for it.
Or they probably might get stolen if they just smash the window in.
Do you know what I saw today when I was in CEX? RTX 2080, they're selling them for $2,000. Graphics card. No, 3080. You know, the big boy. $2,000 they're selling them for.
For a graphics card?
Yeah. Because you can't get them for love nor money.
Wow.
But if you trade one in, they'll give you £1,500.
Hey, we've been waiting for that.
Jesus. Hey, there we go. Jesus. Is it worth buying Harry Potter and Bloomy?
Yes. God, yes.
I've only seen the first Harry Potter's and I'm not interested in the rest, but I do have them digitally. So I would not.
Okay. I still need to watch my 4Ks. Picked up the 4K box set.
Yeah, I've got it here.
I'm not a fan, but my wife loves them. That's probably why.
Is yours British or Italian?
British.
Mine's Italian.
Picked it up for about £2.50.
Pardon? I think one costs about 50.
Jesus.
I'm actually not sure where much one was. I can't remember. Probably about 70 quid.
Not bad.
Amazon USA have no more 3D Godzilla Blu-rays in stock, Pete.
You can get it from India.
If you want to risk that, you might bring the old variant back with you.
Check Amazon Canada, because the only places it's coming is US, Canada, and India. That's the only three places getting it.
I wouldn't mind a 3D, but I'm sure Germany will come down in price eventually.
I don't get why we didn't get one. We're always the first to get 3D.
And I don't know why the US got it.
We're always lagging behind.
Yeah.
Paul, did you want the 3D?
Yeah. Okay. But a better version than the Wonder Woman one you sent me, because that wasn't a very good when you sent it. Look at me being kind of like really like, yeah, but make sure it's a good cut. Yeah, if you could find it for me, that would be good, Rob. Thank you.
Oh, when I was in CX, you know, they've got that Wonder Woman Bloodlines.
Hang on. Jamie's going, yes, that's fine. To be honest, I'm going to end it soon anyway, because everybody's at work soon, but yes. Oh, sorry.
But
sorry,
me,
Rob.
Thanks.
Yes. So that's I don't know. Anyway, yes.
Are you frozen?
No, what happened there?
I don't know. Everybody still alive? Anyway, yes, Jamie, thanks for coming on.
No, thank you for having me, guys.
Your finger's twinging, Paulie.
We all should do the Paulie pose.
Oh. That's a Paulie pose.
Yes.
That's a thumbnail.
That's what she's
magic. See you later, guys. Take care.
See you real soon.
Bye-bye.
See you real soon.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
And then there were five.
Now that he's gone, oh,
well, Phil's not a fan of 3D. I love me 3D. I don't know
3D
why.
Is shite. Oh, Phil.
Nah, it's not 3D shite. It always comes down to what you play it on.
Yeah. And if you done properly.
Mm.
It's always quite good in my VR. I remember when I realised that the PlayStation VR plays it without wearing the glasses, and I put Blade Runner 2049 on it, and it looked absolutely stunning.
Mm.
3D shite if in the cinema. And you're trying to put glasses on glasses.
Yeah.
You can get ones that clip onto your glasses. You can get them online.
Yeah. I think I've got some of those, actually. Mum used to wear those.
Oh, Jesus, man.
What?
Marcus Trubridge is here. Hey, guys. Hiya, Marcus.
Hello.
What's this? Lip Sync Fault and Godzilla versus Kong Pictures Freeze. Only joking, I hope. Mark says, but what we watched today? I haven't watched anything because I've been being a dad and get my COVID jab, unfortunately.
I had to go to Lidl because they were doing LED backlight in package for a TV for $7.99. My daughter watched.
I watched Speed 4K and I watched Lake Mungo.
You watched it?
Mm. And played Resident Evil.
And played Resident Evil again.
And what do you think of Lake Mungo?
It's interesting.
I was at work looking out the window watching the seagulls take a shit on my car.
Understandable.
And you need to wash that off straight away because that can fuck your paint up.
Absolutely. Luckily, it pissed it down tonight, so it's washed most of it off.
What about? It's not raining here yet.
Lake Mungo is good. Lake Mungo is good. If you haven't seen it, check out. I would recommend watching it. Don't watch it in the day. Watch it when it's dark.
Why is it set at night?
If you can. It's just a film you need to watch like a bit more of an atmosphere rather than your curtains open with volume on level one.
Is it that scary?
I didn't think it was really scary. It's more psychological. More. It depends what scares you.
Okay.
That offer got cancelled, didn't it? That cheap $12.99.
Well, it went from $12.99 and everybody bought it. And then it went to $15.99 and everybody bought it. And then they went, shit. And then just cancelled everything and then took it off the website.
Yeah, bastards.
Because I've never seen it. So the fact that I'm going to be able to watch it before it comes out, that might influence whether I'm going to buy the special edition or not, I guess. Mm. I don't want to go and buy it.
That's why I searched for the hard def one because people couldn't get it. So fuck it, I'll find it.
Fair enough.
Guess what I found? Who knows Diamond Lux?
Diamond Lights?
Diamond Lux.
Oh, right. I thought you said that was the Diamond Lights, isn't that a song by
Kevin? Steelbook that comes in, it folds out into four. You've got Gone with the Wind, Gremlins, Green Mile, there's about two or three others. Very rare.
I've got Gone with the Wind, and I managed to pick up Gremlins last night on eBay for £9. I've never seen that.
No, Peter, you've always gone with the wind.
Oh, yeah. I agree with that. And I picked up the Green Mark for like £6. Both Diamond Luxes. Can't believe I found those two.
Wow. I was on video message with Peter a couple days ago. His missus walked in and he's just as he fired. George straight out.
Yeah, she smells it. She slaps me and walks out.
Well, just come to just watch someone to watch over me, Tom Berenger.
Okay.
I liked him in Sniper.
Good film.
What did I want to watch tonight? I was going to watch that. That Woman in the Window wanted to watch. That Late Mungo wanted to watch.
What's Late Mungo on your own?
But I want to see that. Enjoy that. The Devil. I really want to
watch
this.
The Host? Did you watch The Host?
Yeah, I've got it.
Have you seen it?
Host?
Yeah.
The one like this, but it's like paranormal stuff.
Yeah.
I enjoyed that.
Okay. That was quite scary. I was quite surprised with that, to be honest.
That's all here, I believe. If I move him out of the way, this is the one that everybody is. This one.
Yeah.
Mm. I haven't watched this yet because I've watched it, but I mean, I need to watch it.
I haven't seen it.
It's good.
Tell me one thing, like, I wish that when you sent me, and I'm not being ungrateful, but I wish when you sent me this guy, it came with a stand because I can't get him. Every time I put him up,
has anyone seen what's underneath Baby Yoda? He's got no feet. He's like a, like if you turn him out, he's like a.
Get a kitchen roll holder and stick it up his ass.
He's like,
do you remember when you was younger? Do you remember when you was younger? Obviously, when you're in the house, did you ever have them?
It's like the whole dolls.
Did you have the dolls that went over the toilet rolls?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
what were they called again?
They were like Barbie dolls, but they set them on toilet rolls.
Yeah.
They were like flamenco girls, weren't they?
Yeah.
I'm back there. Yes, but they were called like begin with D or something.
D.
Oh, yeah.
Dolls?
No. It was like a name for them. Not dildos.
Dispenser of toilet roll.
I don't have any problem holding my baby Yoda up because I have a couple of porgs that keep him company on each side.
No. I change his shirt every now and again. We've got. I bought some of the Hedgehog Analyzer. Can't wait for the next one. We are getting Knuckles. My kids absolutely loved it. My daughter, no word of a lie, when she came home from school on Friday, she went, "Daddy, the friends at school have seen Sonic the Hedgehog 2 and they say it's really good. Have you got it?" And I went, "It's not out yet. They just finished filming it." No. My friends have seen it. And at that point, I didn't want to go to cause an argument. And I went, "All right, I'll look into it for you then." It's not out
I think
yet.
Knuckles wasn't the first one. At the beginning, there's a load of it. He's in the kidney. I don't even know what Echidna is, but he's an echidna. And when Sonic's getting chased out of Green Hill Zone, whatever, there's a load of them behind him. So I think that's Knuckles.
Is it?
I think.
Obviously, we saw Tails at the end of the first one, didn't we? So.
Who's that one?
Jim Carrey, back on form.
Appears on, who comes on my streams? Is it Rehan that's always saying, "Oh, I've just come from the future. I've seen Wonder Woman 27 and
Rehan Diaz.
Rehan, yeah.
What's that guy all about? Because people always talk about him.
The what?
People always talk about that guy, don't they? In other posts. Is he just a bit peculiar, or is he like?
Don't know.
Or is he a cunt?
I don't know. It's like the bleeding, would you prefer coffee or tea ones I keep getting?
Oh, yeah, I just delete them as we go through.
Have you had any today or not?
I've deleted Paulie's favourite number one fan because it was just getting
you
annoying.
Did what?
Yeah, sorry. I don't want to burst the bubble, but I don't think
that. Yeah, I know about that one. Film on the hunt for that one as well, the Batman one, yeah. So I'm just reading the messages ahead.
Oh. Anyone hunting tomorrow, which I'm Paulie, do you think Lou and Claire would do a stream on Sunday? Oh, well, you've already answered that previously, haven't you?
I'm now worried about what kind of questions we're going to get on that.
But me and Rob won't be on it, so it'll be all right.
You should get, we could make an appearance.
Yeah. We could call it.
And I promise not to be a dirty bastard.
Yeah, that's clearly
Yeah, that's never happened, is it?
What we got? Oh, here we go. That's a great film, Alan. Ridley Scott. That must be the Tom Berenger one. Yeah. It's a good movie film. Okay. It's out tomorrow on Indicator. Yes, it arrived yesterday. Nice.
Ronnie Corcher, nice.
Are you still playing Days Gone, Paul? I am. I have finished the main storyline of the game, and I am now just clearing up other storylines. I'm not doing the hordes because the hordes annoy me because they kill me all the time. But yes, I enjoyed it. I hope they do a sequel. But yes, I have technically finished the game, but I'm just doing the side missions now. There you go. What's the most frightening movie you've watched? We had that earlier on, didn't we? I said Sinister. You said Insidious. Actually, no, it's probably Birds of Prey, I think, yeah. Or Spice Girls, the movie. Or Spice World, the movie. That was pretty scary. Oh,
they're doing another one of them, aren't they?
They are, yeah. I'll probably go and see that. Said no one ever. No. anybody else? Oh, we're doing that. There's a Batman 1-2, Pete.
Yeah, that's the Diamond Luxes.
Oh, okay. Rian was the one who said his mum. He said his mum drinking blood under candles. Oh, okay.
Okay.
Oh, mummy issues.
We'll be watching the 4K Battle Royale tonight. Disappointing, the second movie it's set isn't in 4K. I do have both the 4K, the standard Blu-ray version of the set. Keeping the standard Blu-ray set sealed. Yeah, I started watching it last night, Battle Royale, before I went to bed. I haven't seen it in ages, and I can't remember the second one, but I've got it. And Rob and I had the discussion. But yeah, picture quality is pretty good. But I definitely think for the price, unless you've seen Battle Royale and you like it, then only get the other one. Because if you're paying 60 whatever quid for the 4K or whatever box set, I wouldn't pay that for a film I haven't seen before, especially when you're going to go in blind.
You want to buy it blind. It'd be ridiculous to buy it blind.
Yeah. The Battle Royale Steelbook's 12 quid on Zavvi right now.
Yeah, but that, see, what they've done with Blu-ray, Arrow did with that is they released two Amaria versions of it, director's cut and the normal cut. Whereas when they released the window boxes, which is the one I've got, it's got both of those in it plus a special feature. Anyway, go back to seeing earlier. If people obviously got the money and they want to go out and buy it, blind buy it when they can, but just from my own perspective, unless I've seen it, I don't really want to pay 60 quid on something. Yeah. You know, that's not saying people can't do it, just because people are watching this and think I'm saying that you can't watch it or anything. You know, you want to go and buy something, it's up to you. But just from my perspective, I don't want to buy something for 60 quid if I haven't seen it. There you go. Especially when Rob can send it to us for free. Allegedly. Yes. So I'm just going to Just that there's little terms and conditions with that comment. Anyway, what we're going to do is I'm going to, because it's quarter to 11 now, we'll give it another 5 minutes, guys. You all right with that?
Yeah.
Cool.
Good night, guys. Great stream again. Thanks so much, Legends. Welcome, Scott. Glad you're still here, or we're here.
Okay, Scotty boy.
Because we're more or less up to date with the questions anyway. What's the funniest movie you've watched?
Blazing Saddles.
I would have to say, on the first viewing, because I'd seen it loads of time, Dumb and Dumber.
I was about to say that too. I was just about to say that as well.
Or maybe Me, Myself and Irene. And In Between his first movie.
Yeah.
You wouldn't say the first American Pie? The first time you see American Pie?
That wasn't as laugh out loud as I thought it would be.
I really like Trains, Planes and Automobiles. I think it's a hilarious film.
So I've never seen that.
Mine would be See No Evil, Hear No Evil.
Oh, that's
a classic. Is an absolute classic. That's so.
Was a woman.
There was a stage I used to watch all them, like that, Stir Crazy, when they were all together as well.
Yeah.
Stir Crazy, good. But going back to the Me, Myself and Irene, I just love it when he has that split persona. And he goes to the cash machine, he goes, can we get a check here, Vegisil? And he goes, a little too much cheese on the taco. Oh, Vegisil aisle three, Vegisil aisle three. Just love that bit. So good. But yes. How would you rank the Johnny English movies? Oh, I've only seen the first one.
Shit, shit, and shit.
Oh, no, come on now.
I never got the Bean thing either, Mr. Bean. It's not a... maybe I need to watch him again. I'm not a fan.
No, I could be wrong, but the Johnny English, was that the spin-off from his Bartley card character?
Yeah, I think it was, yeah.
Because it was the same psychic was in...
His other character, his partner, was in the ad as well.
Yeah, I thought so. But yeah, I used to love Mr. Bean. But Johnny English, you watched the first ones, but I guess it's so predictable. You know what you're getting, slapstick, you know, things like that.
Just, Natalie Imbruglia.
In the third one, I went to see the third one with Claire at the cinema. There was a funny scene in it when he was on a boat with the VR headset on. That was a really funny scene.
Yeah. He's crawling along the street, isn't he?
I'll have to watch him. I didn't mind the first one. Because isn't that one where he gets caught on the speeding camera and he goes back around and blows it up or something?
Yeah.
Have you seen Cinema Massacre's 10 Reasons Blu-ray Sucks video? No.
I've not watched Cinema Massacre for years, to be honest.
I probably won't.
Okay. Thanks for being on tonight. Love you guys. Stay safe. You're welcome. Thanks for coming on, Jimmy. I know that obviously we put out if people wanted to come on. So obviously James jumped on it. Paulie's jumped on it. You know, he could have been having spent time with his dad, but he's come and spent time with us. I mentioned James.
Yeah, my dad actually come through the door probably about 20 minutes ago. Right, I'm fucking. I'm going to bed now.
Okay. Mark's, I'm off now. Night, guys. Spaceballs is one, if not the funny. Yes, Spaceballs.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Spaceballs. Did you read about... There was going to be a sequel to Spaceballs, but it was going to be called Spaceballs 3, The Search of Spaceballs 2. And I thought that was brilliant. I thought it was such a brilliant title.
Yeah, it's a great title.
I love the bit where they say, comb the desert.
That is a big comb.
Yeah. Found anything? We ain't found shit! I love that. Yeah. An Afro
comb. Battle Royale is my favourite movie. I now have every edition of it. Also put a 3-disc edition blue of it today from someone about 2 months ago. That's good. £5 is very good. I think I picked my window box up off eBay for £6, which I was happy with.
I think we see one in CX or Fiverr, but I don't think it's a window box.
Was it Battle Royale that you said was a more violent Hunger Games?
Well, Hunger Games ripped off Battle Royale, basically.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I need to see
that. It's a great film. Two is absolute shit.
I haven't seen two for a long time, but the first one is really, really good. If you think
first half Hunger Games is good.
Hunger Games crossed with The Hunt, but better. It's just such an iconic. It's such an iconic film. It's so good.
Yeah, you wish it upon so many kids you knew when you were a kid.
You really would.
We should maybe sort Battle Royale right now. Stories and names in the hand. Awesome. It's like the Purge. Purge needs to happen in Liverpool or Grays, like once a month.
Right, okay. Oh, yeah, speaking of which, did you see the Forever Purge trailer? That looks a bit different.
I've not seen any of the Purge films.
Oh, you need to sort that out, son. They're awesome. Really? There's a series
as well, isn't
there? I still need to watch that.
There is.
Oh, yes. What? Well, there is. Okay, yes. But, yeah, that's the end of the comments, guys. That's it. We're all done. So I think what we'll do then, 2 hours, 20 minutes. Thank you for James for coming on. Thank you for Paulie for coming on. Thanks to Rob for not saying the C word too many times. And thanks for Pete for not shitting himself. There we go.
You say that you still got gout.
This is true.
Thanks.
We are back next week with Leon Talks Film. Oh, there we go. Scott's, but I take it back, Roll. It's good then. It's awesome, Scott. Yes.
Oh, yes. Good.
Back next week with Leon. So stay tuned for that. Don't forget to subscribe to James and Pete and Rob and this man here so he can get more views and more.
I need subscribers.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Give us some of yours.
Yeah, hand them out. Not the big fan, though. Don't want that one. That's fine. But yes, anyway, thank you very much for watching, everybody. And we'll see you next week with Leon. Bye for now.
Bye. Okay, bye.